Hey, Sectus.
Hello.
Hello. What game? Snowcat Simulator.
Oh, don't you mean Port Simulator
No,
Hamburg?
that's the game we tried to get to work for 2 hours and didn't, so we're playing this game instead. Haha.
Woo! Aha!
This game seems to be a lot better anyway. It crashed.
Really? You're keeping that recording going, damage.
I'm in the game, and this is the first thing I see. God, okay, I'm getting in my faithful truck, and I'm gonna show you the mam jammas. Wait, you're just gonna leave it there,
What?
or is that you? Did you get it up right again?
I pressed the reset button.
There's a reset button?
Yeah, R.
Wow.
Ow! Oh,
What? I'm helping.
my Jesus. I'm gonna
Right.
go to the magical mountain.
I'm gonna go to the magical mountain as well. I wonder if I can get in your vehicle again.
This thing is so bad at turning.
Yeah, I know, right? The controls are actually just really awful. Like, it's actually kind of great that you're steering and that I can actually sort of spectate your car, because now seamlessly it's as if I'm just looking on your screen. It's like, wow, I sure enjoy driving on my life. So here's Sectus. This is a pretty good game. This was one of the first things discovered upon playing this game. The driver doesn't seem to be too bothered by what's going on. Like, he has a pretty his emotion, his state of mind is like, yep, this is my life.
Just driving my Snowcat.
Just driving my
Oh,
Snowcat.
whoa.
What did you just do?
I tried to drive forward.
Can you press L, please?
L?
Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, thank you as well. I did not do that.
The
Oh, God.
lights are so bright on this
Yeah,
thing.
holy shit.
It's so horrible, but what, it's a simulator. I guess that's how it is in the reals.
Yeah, like.
Oh my G. Sectus, can you press V a couple times? Because I don't think you're very good at controlling this thing, and I'm gonna show you how to get on the magical mountain. I don't know what. Oh god, you're in one of those. You're coming for me.
One of those.
Also, I'm pretty sure the controls are like reversed when you try to drive backwards. Because whenever I try to steer when I'm going backwards, it's just not going in the right direction.
I think that might be because of what are those things called? Not wheels, the thing you're driving on.
Tracks, I guess.
Yeah, tracks. I think that's actually how it's supposed to be. Maybe, I don't know.
God, why is this game so realistic?
I don't know. It's too good for us.
It's too good for us, but okay, I'm gonna show you how the magical mountain drivers in ancient times used to drive on their own magical mountains, because there's a special technique that comes with this, which is called holding the forward button and hope your car moves. Oh.
Hello.
And I guess you're pretty aware of that technique, because I'm pretty sure you did the exact same thing as I just did, but
Shall I help you?
no, I got this. I
Sure.
got this. It's great as well, because I'm holding forward and it takes like 10 seconds before the car actually starts moving. Oh.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's you're
Well,
getting somewhere. You're
yeah,
getting somewhere.
this is different. Maybe if I try to approach it from a different angle. Maybe that gives me the vantage point I need. Like, as you can see, my car is just apparently I'm moving at 7 kilometers per hour. And I find that questionable because I'm standing still. But you know, that's just the game knows. I don't know about speeds and this thing's potential. So
Did you know you have gears?
I do?
Yeah, 1, 2, 3.
Holy crap. I mean, it's not really gonna be used right now because I can't really go into third gear when climbing up a mountain, but
Well, you don't know. Did you try it?
I guess I did not.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, that's true. That's true. True enough. But here we go. We are going on our own little voyage. We're gonna show you a world. Boom. Here's the lights. It's just beautiful, right? Shall we? I actually have a sight to show you. which I haven't shown you previously.
Ooh.
Uh-huh. But for that, I need to get in a different vehicle. I'm just going to...
Shall I get into the same one?
Yeah, sure.
Similar one nearby.
Wait, I think I got the same one as you now. I need the little orange one because I think it's faster.
Okay, I'll follow you in another orange one.
Yeah. Like, there's one behind me right now.
What about this one?
Which one are you? Oh, there you are. Oh,
right,
yeah,
that
works. Yeah, I don't look in front of me.
Oh, my shit.
What?
You're a ghost.
I am?
There's no one in that vehicle. You're
there
driving.
Is someone in that vehicle driving.
I don't see anyone. You're a ghost.
I see someone. We look exactly the same, but that doesn't mean I'm not
You're
there.
You're a ghost.
I'm not a ghost. Oh, my
You're
God.
You're a ghost car.
Stop calling me a ghost. Okay. So there's people skiing on this thing, this mountain. Whoa, this thing steers like a mamma jamma. It's actually pretty crazy.
Arks.
It's actually pretty hard to control any vehicle in this game, but I guess that's because it's a simulator. But if we can find a skier man, then I can show you one of the greatest things. Okay. That was pretty great too as well. Because whenever we... Whoa. Whenever we hit each other, it seems like magical things happen to our physics. And then we just sort of fly into a new dimension. I'm stuck on you right now, by the way. So you're basically controlling me. There you go.
So left or right here?
I don't know. It seems like the ski area is pretty empty right now. So we might have to go back to this later.
What if we go up? Maybe find ski people there?
Yeah, maybe. We could give it a shot. But there's a lot of different directions the skiers can go, though. So I don't know if we'll find someone. But I guess we might as well go on a little adventure while we're at it, because why
yeah.
not?
Yeah, I like adventures.
Yeah. I'm having trouble switching gears, though. I don't think I'm really doing anything with it.
I pressed 3. I don't know if I'm going faster or not.
I don't think I'm going faster, but it says I'm going 40 kilometers per hour. And there's a lot of motion blur on my vehicle right now, and it's kind of scaring me.
I'm 43.
That's pretty good. The thing is, though, it said I was going 7 kilometers per hour earlier when I was standing still, so I'm not really sure how reliable that thing is.
Do you think we can ski with these vehicles?
I would be pretty happy if we could. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna lie. But if you see any skier, just try to collide with it.
Oh, shit.
What?
I was testing buttons.
Did you press V again?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is pretty good. This is a pretty good multiplayer game, I think. I mean, this game has 8-player multiplayer as well.
Yeah.
I don't think there's even 8 vehicles in the game, so I think that's pretty nice that they put 8-player multiplayer in the game.
We did ask other people to buy it and play with us, but for some reason they said no, I don't
yeah,
understand.
Yeah, they were like, hey, we are not spending 20 euros on this, and we were like, why not? This is a quality game. There's magic mountains. There's people skiing, there's physics that change every now and then. It's like NASCAR racing. Need for Speed 4.
Yeah, look at the speed.
Like, in that game, you have to type a cheat to turn off gravity. In this game, it just happens randomly. And to be fair, I think that's a pretty good selling point.
I don't find the ski peoples.
Yeah, there's really no one here, is there? It's kind of distressing. But I think that's just... I think they're just shy, to be honest.
You know what is a good game?
What is a good game?
Ski Free, just saying.
Ski Free was highly popular in its time.
It was pretty good.
I think everyone agreed that it was basically just symbolic. It truly showed symbolism way beyond our imaginations back then.
If we didn't have Ski Free, we would not have this game.
Without Ski Free, we wouldn't have snow.
Yeah.
Or skis. Ski Free invented skiing.
And skiing would not be free.
Yeah.
Just with Ski Free.
Like before Ski Free, skiing costs $12 per hour, even though skiing wasn't invented yet.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
Yeah, but nowadays you can ski entirely for free if you do it illegally enough. So I think that Ski Free truly revolutionized. How big is this mountain? Like, we played Port Simulator before this, and it barely worked. But there was like an invisible wall. Like, after about 5 minutes of driving our little tugboat in the water. But in this game, we just keep moving.
Yeah, this is basically large enough like GTA 5, I think.
I think so, too. Like, GTA 5 probably got inspiration from this game.
Obviously.
And they were like, we can't quite do that much, but we can try.
Yeah.
Man, this is pretty exciting.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely so. It's interesting though, because you know, it just makes me glad to be alive.
Oh.
It just reminds me of the good old days where skiing just, you know, just skiing. You know what I mean?
This fence is kind of funky.
What do you mean? I don't see what you mean. That's how fences work. Have you never simulated your life before? I mean, really? Really, Sectus? You never tried to drive on a fence? Was this not exactly what happened the last time you tried to drive on a fence, Sectus?
You know, you have a fair point. Like, I haven't tried this. I don't know. Like, maybe that would happen.
This is simulation of real life. This is what happens when you try to drive on a fence. And to be fair, I think it's pretty realistic. Because the last time I drove on a fence, I got this exact experience.
Oh, God, stand still.
I can't. Well...
I can't.
I'm trying to stop. It takes a while.
Oh, I'm trying to. Okay. Okay. Stand still.
I'm standing still.
Hold you.
Okay. No! You're stealing my... Get out of here! You're stealing my gasoline. How dare you? Okay, Sectus.
Yeah?
I need you to push me.
I think the invisible walls are probably pretty tall, I'm gonna bet. Oh, Jesus.
Have you... the magical mountain, though.
Yeah, like, this is a reason we should have more people in this, because, like...
We would have 8 people to all push our one car over this wall.
Yeah, that'd be amazing.
That would be pretty great, even though I'm still pretty sure there's not 8 cars in this game. Like, it would still be, like...
Actually, I think there might be.
Are there, though? Like, let's see. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Oh! Maybe.
Yep.
And if not, then there would just be one person who could motivate the other people by just cheering them on. And, like, you can high-five people in this game. So, like, I don't see why people would dislike this game, because it just shows... It shows you things, you know? My car came to a complete standstill. Oh, there we go. Whoa!
Oh.
That was interesting. So, that doesn't happen in most games, but it does in this one. I'm gonna see if I can hit that ski lift.
I think I have determined this vehicle doesn't have any special abilities.
I'm gonna get in the ski lift. I'm in the ski lift. I'm now physically part of the ski lift, so... Okay, let's drive our little wagon down. Let's ski down. Like in Ski Free. Are you like the monster in Ski Free?
Ooh, he's so scary.
Yeah, you have to hold like a button to escape from him, otherwise he gets you.
It's kind of scary.
It's pretty scary, actually. Like, I was actually quite scared when I first saw that, and I don't think I've ever actually played Ski Free. So that's pretty, like,
wait,
you have to...
Wait, you played Ski Free?
I don't know. I don't think I have.
What?
Like, I've seen Ski Free, and I know you have to hold a button to go faster to escape the monster, but that's really all I know about Ski Free.
That was such a good game.
I just never really felt the urge to ski for free, you know? Like, I was still in the mindset that you had to pay $12 per hour.
Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame.
Yeah, it's hard to get out of that mindset once you're into, like, the $12 hour mind, you know? Like, I guess you know what that's like, because you're, like, 500 years old, and back then everything cost $12 as well.
Oh, back in my day.
There you go. That's the sound of oldness.
Back in my day, we just talked gibberish. We didn't have words back then.
Yeah, like those were the days, but no. They ruined it.
Park here.
Yeah. What was the reset button?
R, but I don't think it works for this vehicle.
Oh. Well, that's unfortunate.
I'm good at parking.
Yeah, I am too, I feel.
Should we press V?
Yeah, I'm just gonna see what happens if I hit the little round things over here.
Yeah.
Because I'm quite curious. Well, there you go.
I pressed B.
I'm just gonna make these things go into the corner.
I have something to show you.
I made something spasm so much that it flew away.
Awesome.
Yeah. What do you have to show me, my little friend?
Jump into my vehicle or a close one.
I'm just gonna park this car like inside a fence, and I'm gonna see you where. Oh, there you are. I'm gonna get into the little snowmobile because I'm quite a fan of the small Snowcat to transport a supply sledge to lift the station.
Very good, very good. Follow me.
I'm trying to move. It's tricky, but
you should drive into things.
I'm just trying. I might as well try to see if I can transport this little thingy to the place, you know?
Is that how you transport?
That's how you transport. Like, use small Snowcat, use Q to attach back plow. Boom. We got it. Might as well do some missions while we're at it, you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, follow me.
Following you. Following orders, sir. I'm Rebecca.
Acknowledged.
Acknowledged. Engaged.
For king and country.
For king and country. I think your car's faster than my car.
You hit
it's no longer.
Because of stuff like this.
I don't think your car's faster than my car anymore.
Follow me.
Where are all the skiers though? Because I remember seeing one and I was very impressed with when I hit it.
Was that in single player or was that multiplayer?
No, that was definitely a multiplayer because I only tried multiplayer. Maybe he's just hanging out, just having some hot cocoa. Oh. Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's there, I guess. Is that a vehicle we can control? Because that would be pretty cool.
I don't think it is. That would be pretty cool.
Yeah, I want to fly the eyes. Like, just the eyes, actually. Oh, I have an idea, I think. Like, it's going to be tricky because controlling any vehicle in this game is like controlling, like, a cat, really, that you're trying to put in the water.
Is that an invisible wall?
That is an invisible wall, and my idea just went. It's more like an invisible bouncy castle. Because I just flew. I don't know, maybe we can engage magical mountain mode again if we hit it correctly.
Should one of us actually try to do the objective?
I'll do it in a second, but first I want to get through this invisible wall. That's priority number one right now.
Holy shit!
Sectus, I need a push. Oh, come on, we got this. We got this. You were swearing? Oh. What? Sectus?
Whenever you have some time, just press V until you get to a car which just goes crazy whenever you select it.
I'll just check now. I parked my car pretty well. I don't see any crazy cars.
Oh my Jesus, really?
Oh, there you go. Yeah, that's the one I parked inside the fence. Because the fence wasn't very solid. Oh,
yeah,
that's interesting.
Look at that.
Yeah, simulation. Okay, yeah, no, that's good. That's how cars work. That's, yeah.
I just do this all day.
What is going on with this car?
Is this happening every time I select it?
It seems so. Whoa, the thing's flying! I don't know if it's when you select it or if it's just like when it hits a certain part of this fence, because...
I guess that's it.
The fence is pretty wacky. Okay, I'm going back to my my little Snowcat, I think.
Oh, okay.
I may need some help, because my little Snowcat is having some trouble.
I'm just going to park this other car in the fence as well, then I'll come to you.
Okay, maybe I'll just use the other vehicle myself to get the Snowcat out of here, because this is not really working right now.
I can help. I'm helpful.
Oh, there you go. Right, so I've nearly engaged Operation Magical Mountain, but I'm still a little bit stuck, as you can probably see.
This is helping.
I feel helped right now. I've positioned myself.
Helping.
Yeah, this is moving. This could be an issue. Whoa, I can see through the world right now.
Oh, awesome.
If you can switch to my vehicle and then just move your camera all the way down. Like, I think that would,
Wow.
Yeah.
Ahead of its time, this
it's game. It's ahead of its time. It lets you, like, see the world for what it truly is. Like, no bars hold, you know?
Yeah, it's a very, a controversial
It's a controversial statement towards physics in general, Because a lot of people don't actually believe that physics are real, but they've actually proven physics to exist.
And this might like solve cheating in shooters by just allowing everybody to like use wall hacks.
Yeah, like in a lot of games, there's like third-party programs to be the meanies that the internet sometimes contains. But in this game, they put everything on an even playing field.
Very good.
Yeah. There's really very little I have to do to like get this thing stuck. My reset button stopped working, by the way.
Oh. Where are you?
I reset my vehicle. And, oh, hey. If I, like, press C to, like, switch out my vehicle, some pretty great things happen.
What are you doing?
No, it's actually pretty good because, like, just look at me for a moment. With this vehicle...
Whoa! I tried to turn.
Apparently so. But, like, if I just, like, run into, like, a wall or something, then it's like, okay, yeah, cool. But then if I... Okay, sometimes it goes a bit wacky because I hadn't even pressed...
That was good.
I hadn't even pressed the button yet, but, like, it just goes like this. But then I press C, and it, like, positions itself perfectly to fall over. And I think that's beautiful because there's just not many games that let you do that, you know?
A thing of beaut,
indeed. Okay, I'm gonna do the first mission.
Okay.
It's been exciting so far, but I feel that we should help humanity.
I feel it's kind of unfair because there's only one small snowcat, right?
Yeah, but you can like spectate me as
I'm
doing.
Okay, I can. Do you know where the supply sledge is?
Yeah, it's behind me. It's a little yellow dot.
Okay.
I just need to move backwards a bit.
Oh, I can be one of those rally co-drivers.
Oh yeah, you can tell me if there's a hard right. Once my car starts moving again, which is probably in a few seconds. There we go. Like we got this.
Hard left.
That's not even a turn. Oh, I might. Oh, I found the multiplayer. Oh no, never mind. I thought I found the multiplayer part in that my car got stuck entirely, but then that's it. I forget sometimes that this game doesn't actually have normal movement.
Kind of sad I can't do anything while in your vehicle.
Yeah, it's kind of a shame. It's like the first person who starts to control a vehicle is the master of its domain. Which is kind of a shame. I'm gonna try to find that skier, man, because I'm genuinely curious. Oh, I should steer, I guess. You didn't tell me there was a heart left. I thought you were my rally driver, man.
You did even attach the supply sledge.
Yes, I did.
What? Where?
There's like a yellow dot on my car right now, and that's the supply sledge. It's like really small and on the back of me right now.
I see a red thingy on your back. Is that it?
Yeah.
That's nothing.
Shut up. Don't be so negative all the time.
Oh my god, you're gonna get us fired.
Press T to detach. See, this was helpful.
Okay, you weren't kidding. You were actually carrying something.
Yeah, see, I can move it, I can take it out, I can put it back in. Like it's filled with greatness.
Well, sure, if you say so.
I would never lie. I'm having some trouble getting this to the lift station, but I think if I press C, then things usually come out okay.
You need my help.
I might.
I'm a bit far away, but I'll try to get to
it. I'm like slowly like evolving. I'm slowly becoming one with the lift station. I'm really not entirely sure where I'm supposed to be taking this thing.
I see a yellow icon on the map. That isn't like an objective marker, is it?
Well, I thought so, but it's not really gonna be anywhere. Like, I guess I was kind of far away when I placed it there previously, but... like, I'm just having some doubts that that is the place where it needs to be, you know? Because nothing really changed the moment I detached it earlier, but I might have just been too far away from the marker.
I see a yellow icon basically behind you. Maybe that's where you're supposed to place it.
I guess so, but where are you? What are you? How are you?
I'm help.
You are not
help. I am help.
You are not
help. Here, have help.
I feel helped in some ways, but I also feel stopped in others.
Help.
I'm not feeling it right now. I'm not feeling like I am
help
progressing. You are just pushing me further in the wrong direction.
Help.
Do I need to get a third car here just to get the stupid thing?
Help.
Stop saying help and driving into me.
Okay,
oh my god.
Okay.
Like, at least drive into me from like a normal angle so I can actually help, like, use it for movement, say, purposes.
Well, I don't have many angles to work with her.
There's like the other angle. Like, that one's a good one. That, see? This is much better. As you can see, this is helping us progress into new levels. New territories are being discovered right now. Are you serious? Oh. Try driving now. Yeah. Try driving in the direction to get us out of here, you silly Billy.
I'm trying.
Hold backwards, boy. Oh my god. I can see your back wheels spinning like crazy.
This is not going well.
No. We're getting somewhere. We're evolving into new bonds of friendship. And I feel that it's helping us get to a new level. Maybe not in the game, but definitely in our own life.
I've unstuck myself now.
I'm still finding myself to be in somewhat of a pickle.
Nope.
You're doing it again. You're doing the thing again, which has previously already led us to some nonsensical areas, but... Okay. Farewell, my son. Okay, take us away. No! Hang on, I'm just gonna get another vehicle here. I think there should be one, yeah. There we go. It's gonna take a while to get there, but I think in the end it's gonna be very worthwhile.
Will we ever do task one?
Task one is difficult. Like, this game...
It is difficult.
It takes itself very seriously in terms of realism. And I respect that personally.
Yeah.
This car is way too far away. I don't know why I chose that one. This one's
I guess we did actually drive pretty far up the mountain.
We went to a new life. Is what we did. And I find that the game should respect our life choices. Hold Q to attach front plow. Oh, hey.
Oh, yeah, if you're using a thing, I think you're using, you have a bunch of things you can...
Yeah, I can, like, do stuff. Like, maybe this will get us to where we need to be. Like, I can use the front plow to, like, pick up my little vehicle and just carry it to where it needs to go.
Yeah.
Then it doesn't need to tire out its little wheels anymore, because... It's a little car, and driving large distances can be a bit tricky for, you know,
a little
such,
car.
Such small legs. Car legs.
Cars but have feelings too.
Yeah, cars have... If you've ever seen the movie Cars or watched Putt-Putt Goes to the Moon or Thomas the Tank Engine, like, Thomas was a car at heart. Like, he knew what's up. He had to fight that a lot of different cars had to fight too. I'm fighting I'm actually genuinely quite impressed with how easy that was. Yeah.
Did it help?
I'm back here again. Okay, I guess I'll try a different vehicle. Let's just get this one out of the way first. You're just gonna crash.
Wow, see, I'm getting somewhere.
Am I just gonna get stuck in this tree? Because I feel like I'm just gonna get stuck.
No, I fixed the snowcat.
Holy, wow.
You're a wizard.
You are a wizard. We both came to that same conclusion simultaneously, so it must be true.
I like that your orange vehicle is still moving backwards.
Don't worry about it. There's no one in there. That is the ghost vehicle.
I see.
I'm kind of curious if we could just get one at the top of the mountain and then make it go all the way down. Maybe that's the purpose of this game.
I'll make the top one go down. Let's see where it's at.
Okay. I'm going to try to get into the little yellow marker.
No, that's the one. That's the right one. Okay.
This is so stupidly difficult. Like, you don't understand until you start playing this game how... utterly useless the controls are. Like, I'm holding forward right now and it's still going backwards. I've been holding forward for like a large amount of time now, and it's
it helps. Shall I push you?
No, stop, don't move. Why?
I'm help.
My forward button is just not doing anything anymore. Which is a bit of an issue, because I actually need that button to move. I may need some help. I may need you to push me, like, into the marker, because I'm just not moving anymore. Oh, okay. Okay, a little bit further. Oh, okay, we got this.
Oh, no. Oh, well, maybe that counts. Oh, yeah.
Okay, I can move again.
Okay. Now detach.
Oh, detach is T.
Okay.
Okay.
Good job. Now thanks. Move away, or...
Oh, yeah, I'm going. Oh, yeah.
Are you sure that's a supply sledge?
Well, it has a little... Oh, wait. Hang on. I may have, like, a better idea. Maybe there's, like, a thing which I can attach to this little thing. And, it's gonna be great. Hang on. We got this. I'm just gonna put this back where it belongs. Like, on the back of the great me. I guess this was a bit small. For a sledge. I don't really know what a sledge is. Sectus?
Yeah.
I'm stuck again. Oh, no, wait, there we go. Come on. Press Q to attach toe. I guess this does say toe hook and not sledge. I guess a toe hook is a hook used for towing purposes and not a sledge. Hmm. I'm stuck again.
Ghost car is getting close to you.
Is it?
Yeah.
Where is it?
Well, the one say which was the name Raphael.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not in it.
Oh, okay. Scary, spooky.
Yeah.
Sectus?
Yeah.
I feel like sometimes I make decisions which are not in my best interest.
Why do you go there?
I don't know. I tried, making myself flip over so I could reset back to my original location.
You could just drive back, you lazy salt.
In hindsight, that would have been the better choice. But I feel that in the moment, it wasn't, you know?
I feel in the moment you'd poop.
I can see why you would feel that, but I feel that that's just not correct right now. Maybe you need a larger distance between you and the things that are going on in your life.
A little longer, distance from you.
You need. Oh God, what have I done? Hold. Oh, I guess we're not going for the fuel transfer. You need, a large gap between you and me before you start just bumping into me, you know? I'm going to use a different strategy, which was taught to me back in 1942. It were dangerous times, but back then, sometimes things were necessary.
You'll be impressed.
I'll be the judge of that. See, I can see movement in the distance, but I don't know if I should feel impressed yet. See, I can see a little car moving away, but I still don't know, man. I'm still not 100% sure.
This is so bad a turn.
Oh yeah, it's like the other one. Just like you push one button and you just fly to the other side of the world. But with that vehicle, you try to turn and it just doesn't.
Okay. Let a pro show you how you do a mission, all right?
Okay.
I've got experience with
Watch this. Out, there's gangsters in your way. Ski gangsters have come to stop you in your progress.
Oh no!
Oh god. They are part of the physics mafia. And they feel that no one should have the same access to the physics as everyone else.
Oh dear lord.
It's pretty scary, but... Oh no, you're too good for the physics mafia. But the physics mafia is not just stopped at the first. Did you just drop your toe hook?
Yeah.
Sectus?
Yeah.
We need that toe hook.
You sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure? I want to take this.
Oh, yeah, I want to take this.
I'm gonna take this.
I don't think that's gonna fit on your little snow cat.
I wanna try. Maybe, it may look small, but I'm very strong.
That's a good point.
Kinda in the way of everything.
Well, as you can see, only my front wheels are spinning right now because for some reason we decided to have cars that can only move forward with the front wheels in a very snowy area.
Go away, go!
I'm trying, okay? Like, it's harder than it looks. Like, you would expect, like, the some of the buttons to do things, but no. Sectus?
Yeah, maybe you're right. Maybe I can't attach this.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Such surprise.
Yeah.
Many things have startled me right now. Oh, my car's continuously moving still.
Where are things?
Ooh, well, here's one. Okay. There you go.
I don't think that's what I... That's even bigger than the thing I tried to pick up.
No. Okay, Sectus, give me that car and I will show you.
Okay, Jesus.
I'll get the tow hook. I feel the tow hook is an integral. So yeah. Let's get this show on the road. First by putting the tow hook back in its original location.
How do I attach this?
I seem to have, okay, there we go.
Attach when allowed.
Use small snowcat to transport supply sledge. So what's a supply sledge?
I think it might be a surprise sledge.
I think it might be a surprise sledge as well. But I don't think a lift needs a surprise very much. So in that sense, it makes me feel a little like that's probably not going to be the case, you know? I'm leaving you, by the way. I hope that's fine.
Where are you going?
I think this is where the surprise sledge is. So,
where are you going?
No, it's over here, I swear. I've played this game before, and that's a lie.
Oh, can he go to the ice?
Oh, that's a good question. Maybe that's what they meant with surprise. That it's like a really bad pun. That it's on ice. I drove into a tree, but I don't think
drove into a tree.
It's hard to turn this thing. You firsthand have experience with this. You shouldn't judge
a man. Although
you're
the one getting stuck on the freaking tower, but Jesus.
There's like a hockey field here, so I think this is going to be pretty great.
I don't think you're getting good progress with this sledge.
What are you talking about? It's like, whoa.
Whoa.
I tried to hit the hockey thing, but sometimes turning takes
Oh my god, moving the camera around here is freaky. Like, the reflection on the ice is all over the place.
Yeah, there's a lot of lights in the world. This is a very holy area.
L.
Oh yeah, L. Oh man.
Oh wow.
That only improves things.
Wow.
Nothing except improving.
Wow, look at the shadowing on the hockey.
I'm seriously. Well, yeah, that looks very bizarre. Oh, I went through it. I got a goal. I feel like I got 6 points. I really don't know the rules of hockey, but I feel I got 6 points for that one.
I'm gonna look for the supply sledge.
Okay, you find the supply ledge. And I'm gonna go on a little adventure here.
Let me know if you find anything interesting.
Well, I see some mountains in the distance, and our little friend here has already shown quite a proficiency when it comes to climbing things.
And I still.
Yeah.
I still think it's really unfair. There's only one of those.
Well, that's okay because you can take the little truck that drives like 4 times as fast as this one.
You know. Where the snowcat starts, there seems to be only 2 items you can pick up there.
Yeah, one might say
so
that.
Maybe it's the other item?
But this is the only one that has a little yellow fniffy fnaffy, though.
Well, maybe the other thing has another fniffy fnaffin.
But it didn't seem to have any fniffies or fnaffies.
Did you try?
No. I guess I should, but
Wait. This, okay, so I moved a little bit further away, and this looks like a sledge for carrying supplies. I think this might be the supply sledge.
I have a small question.
What?
What is a sledge?
Like you know, as a kid, you go like...
I thought that was a sled, though.
Well, you just add a G and an E.
Well, that's how you get many words, but that doesn't really mean it's the truth, you know?
Also, there's flammable... barrels
can
in
you,
this ledge.
Can you get in my car for a moment?
Okay.
Because I need you to see this car.
Okay.
Are you in my car right now?
Yeah.
Okay, so you see the little red friend over there, yeah?
Yeah, I also see the blinding light.
That's... I turned it off. But you see this little car, yeah?
So I see you.
You don't see this red car?
No.
That I'm hitting right now with my own car?
No.
Oh, well, that's
are you talking about ghosts again?
I might be. Because there is actually a car here on my screen, and it's doing some pretty magical things. Like, it's a completely empty car as well.
I'll take your word for it.
Maybe this is the surprise sledge, because, like, the supply sledge was just over there, but this one's just a surprise in that it's only on my screen.
Oh, wow. Okay. I'll talk about it. I guess I clicked outside the game window.
Very good.
Stupid dual monitor setup. Do you want to see what the supply sledge is?
Okay, I'll try to get into a position where I have to reset my vehicle, because I'm pretty far away from anything right now. And I don't think...
You know, Garb!
Yeah?
Do you know what happened the last time?
We got some great adventures out of it. There's even, like, a levitating ski lift over here, which doesn't seem to be attached to anything.
You're so far away. If we get stuck now, what will we do?
No, look at the ski lift over there, though. There's, like, people.
Yeah.
Civilizations.
Yeah, that is impressive. I'll give you that.
You'll give me that. Indeed, you will. I'm glad you accept me sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah. It's just that we just... Eventually, we'll get on the same page, and then we're going to have some great adventures. Yep.
You're not getting...
No, I am. No, seriously, look. I'm moving.
You're moving, but you're supposed to be upside down, not moving.
No! Look, I'm...
Okay,
I'm
bridge. Go to the bridge. Go to the bridge.
There's an invisible wall.
Towards the bridge?
Yep.
What?
I'm pretty much hugging the invisible wall right now.
Why don't you go to the bridge?
I don't want to go to the bridge.
I wanted to go to the bridge.
I choose not to.
It looks like good.
I find that bridge is bad business.
It's a good bridge.
That bridge is just put there to attract bad crowds.
That's a tree.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it is.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
What is this?
Yes, it is.
It is?
Yes, it is.
Who is?
The tree.
What tree?
The tree is a tree.
What tree are you talking about? There's no trees here.
Well, the one you drove past.
Is that a Norwegian flag?
Swedish flag.
Oh, I get too confused all the time.
Oh my Jesus. That's
I forget.
That's what happens when you insult my...
Yeah, like the gods of thunder come in and kill my little snow cat with magical mountains. Okay. So there was like a... Are you next to the supply sledge?
Well, I'm in your car right now, technically.
Oh, right. Your name tag is still like way over there.
Okay,
so.
Let's see. Now I am next to the supply.
Can you get back in my car, please? I found the magical mountain.
You made it flat. Oh my Jesus.
Don't worry. I'm just doing like a two-wheel drive.
Okay. Take a right and go down towards the red vehicle.
Okay. I got you so far. Yeah. Oh. Hey, these look like supply sledges.
Yeah.
Maybe this is what we were looking for all this time, hey?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm glad I found this one all by myself. But I think, let's see if we can attach
Wait,
this.
Where are you going?
What? There's a supply sledge here.
I see only one and it's not there.
I see three.
I see... What? Okay. Take the invisible one. Take the invisible...
I can't actually attach this to anything.
Okay, maybe you should go for the one I see too. Maybe that's the only real one.
Is that the one like far and like tell
yes.
me well is I don't know if this is another one which you can't like maybe they just placed at random.
Well, you're going the right direction now for the one I can see.
So this one, yeah.
Yeah, this one is real. It is
okay,
real.
This
it
one's
is most it is not a ghost sledge.
This one is real. I can actually attach to this one.
Yeah.
For a moment. Now I can't.
You need to drive forward. You need to align the thingy with the thingy. There we go. Yeah. Back a little. There you go. Yeah.
Oh, man. We got something going on.
Oh, yeah. Let's do this thing.
Let's do this thing. Try hitting my supply sledge with your car. Okay, I feel this helps.
Okay.
Like, co-op, you know? Yeah, I feel helped right now. I feel that this put us in the right direction in many different ways. Try hitting it again. Oh my. See, this is obviously the way to go. It came off. It still says detach, though. Like, it still says press T to detach, but it's just nowhere near my vehicle anymore.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna detach it. Oh, it does nothing. This could be an issue. My car is still driving forward, even though I've been holding backwards for a while now. It's just not listening to me anymore.
That was worth it.
Can you hit that thing again? Maybe it'll make me fly magically. No, it's just making it roll over, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, at least you're having fun. Yeah, this is pretty good. We're getting somewhere. Oh. Okay, I got the tow hook again. Now okay. I just need to wait for my car to move back. Okay, there we go.
Okay, so that's why you had the detach prompt, because you technically have like two things.
Yeah.
Detached.
Okay, got that. Okay.
Good attempt.
Okay, I put the thing right side up again. And yeah, now I can just put it on the back of my vehicle. Just give it a few moments, you know? Not yet. Got it. Almost going for the kill. I missed. Still. Come on. Okay. Move, you stupid little vehicle. You're not actually going anywhere. Also, my C button stopped doing anything, which I find a bit disconcerting. Can you push me? Oh, no, wait, never mind.
Did you attach the thing?
Nope.
Maybe you should attach the thing?
Oh, that's a pretty good idea, actually.
Yeah.
Do
you need more tips in life in general?
In life in general, yeah.
Okay.
Because I'm playing this game instead of being productive. I mean, I don't really get any prompts anymore.
Really?
Can you push this thing? Like, I get stuck all the time here. Oh, wait, no. Never mind. I might have this. I hate that how realistic this game is.
It's too good.
I'm holding forward for like 5 minutes before anything actually happens, and I feel that is just an issue with realism.
I wonder if there's also lag.
Maybe. It's only when driving forward and backwards, though. Like, there's no lag with steering.
Hmm.
Like, it's just when I hold forward, like, after.
It is actually kind of slow for me as well, so probably not lag.
Yeah. I'm seriously trying. You wouldn't believe how much I'm trying. Like, I'll just get it exactly perfect or something. Drive, please. This is so hard. No, it's just not doing it. Can you push this thing?
Yeah,
because I'm just not
the proper vehicle.
I'm just not getting a prompt for this at all anymore. Maybe we broke it. We have done some pretty magical things with this thing, so maybe we've lost all ability to do anything with it.
Help on the way. Whoa! Shit. Oh no.
Well, that was good.
Did it teleport to you?
It teleported to me and make me fly. So I guess it's still sort of attached to me. I'll try detaching the tow hook again. And reattach. Don't do it. Oh, almost. I got a prompt.
Okay, good.
We're getting there.
Getting there. One of these days, we'll finish task one.
Okay, driving backwards again when I don't mean to.
Good.
Yeah.
You'll get there one day. I believe in you.
I believe very vividly. That's the wrong button. To attach. There we go. Alright. Almost completed task one.
I'm very tempted to drive into you.
I know, and you probably should, but... You probably shouldn't at the same time for different reasons, but mostly you should. Yeah. Yeah, that's good. That's the ticket. That's gonna get us places. Mostly me. It's mostly gonna get me places. Turn. Oh, well then.
I would call that turning.
I, I'm not sure if I would. I'm honestly.
It's just so good. It just keeps on going.
I'm not sure if I would call this turning.
It's a gift. Which keeps on giving.
It's a gift. It is, but I can't actually. Like, I've been holding forward. I just keep driving backwards. I think this thing has started to control my vehicle.
I'll help.
Oh, good. Thanks. It's surprising though, because you only need to like nudge it a bit, and even your vehicle is having a good time with this thing. Like, I'm pretty sure this thing is actually embedded into my vehicle, because I just...
Yeah, it looks kind of old right now.
Yeah. Okay, good.
Maybe if I hug you a little
This
bit.
Is good. We're getting somewhere.
I feel like I need to add another vehicle to the mix here.
Yeah, that's exactly my feelings right now. I feel that the problem we're having right now is that there's not enough vehicles. Okay, I'm getting it there. Maybe not in the overly intended method, but it's moving. Okay.
Oh, fuck.
Attach. I'm sorry, I already got free, but...
It's okay, I can still help.
I know you can. It's
so currently... I'll help once you're attached.
Okay, good. That's exactly the time... Stop driving forward, please. Okay. Cue. Okay, I got it. You can do the helpings now. Oh, you're gonna push me. That's nice.
Yeah.
You know, for such a big vehicle, you're not really that great at this.
Yeah, you're right.
Hey, Sectus.
Yeah.
How's my lights doing?
How much?
Oh my god. That is the brightest.
Where's my other vehicle?
I'm gonna see. Oh, wow. I'm just impressed by this game. Like, if I just drive backwards, that's just enough. That's all it needs. Can you hit that thing? No, actually, don't hit it right now. I think it might still technically be attached to me.
Are you getting fuel?
Yeah, a lot, actually.
Cool.
God, it takes so long. Okay. Come on.
I like that the snow becomes really, really messed up out of everything we're doing.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. It's pretty realistic. But, like, you see me, right? You see me right now.
Yeah.
This is what happens when I drive backwards. Like, apparently, there was not a game tester who was like, hey, let's try driving backwards for a moment.
No. They tested it and they went, yes, feature.
You know, it's actually kind of funny. Like, a long, long time ago, I recorded Mining and Tunneling Simulator.
I remember that.
And one thing which I sadly didn't show, which I found out later, was that it had a pretty similar physics system. In that you can get rocks, like, into your little vehicle. And they seem to function pretty similar to how this thing is functioning when it was in your car. I remember alt-tabbing and going back into the game and then just flying to the moon. And I feel that, you know, it's pretty good. It's pretty good. I don't know what to do with this video, if I should just edit it and to have, like, a highlight video, or if I should have the entire thing.
I don't know.
Because both would...
It'll be a pretty long thing if you're going to upload all of it.
Yeah, and there's not, like, always action, really, is there?
Basically, everything became really truly magical once we found the sledge.
Oh, use the snow blower to clear road in parking place near garage. My thing disappeared and I can't move anymore and just a lot of stuff. I'm getting a different vehicle. This one's not doing what I need it to do anymore.
I think what I'm using right now might be a snow blower. I'm not quite sure, like, this seems to...
Is this a snowblower?
Like, the thing in front, like, it looks like it could do stuff with snow.
Hmm.
I don't know, like it looks like it would, like, absolutely destroy snow.
It probably would, actually, yeah. Because it's orange, and orange is a pretty hot color.
Although, it could be the yellow one. No, that doesn't really do any blowing.
Press X to activate thing on my car right now. I'm also just entirely stuck with this vehicle, which is pretty great. I'll get the red one, because that one seemed to move at least.
So, parking place near the garage.
Yeah, that's a pretty good one. There's a yellow dot on the map, but that might be just
Now you're thinking, that's good. That's
I'm simulating my life. I'm just trying to get, like, vehicles, like, movable again, because some of them are not.
So, we need to clear the road, but this looks already kind of clear.
No, it's not clear enough. Oh, God, my snowblower! What just happened? I think you turned on the snowblower for both vehicles, because it just suddenly started working on this car.
Oh, yeah, I see the distance.
Okay, I got free.
Okay, so I think I'm definitely, like, blowing the snow.
Yeah, oh, I turned it off again, I think. For my... Okay, there we go. I'm gonna turn it off for now. It seems my car drives quicker when I don't have it turned on. It's probably wrong, but, you know. No, actually, it does actually seem to slow me down when I use it, which I guess makes sense because simulation and all that. It's kind of a shame that the skiers are just gone because... I don't know if I can show this off anymore because the skiers are just gone from the world. But the one time I managed to hit a skier, it just went on top of my vehicle. And that was it. That was it. There was no collision aside from it just being on top of my vehicle and skiing along just on top of me. Are we really going to have to clear out this entire thing? Can you turn on cheats to get $10 million like in Port Simulator? Because I think that would help us get a better vehicle.
There are cheat functions, but there's also like a cheat login.
Oh wait, there's a little percentage symbol on the top that says how much we've done. Like if we just clear that, then this is like an MMO. We just have to clear out a certain number of snow enemies, snow beasts. I find this very exciting, personally, because it reminds me of the times where I had to drive a giant orange vehicle to get rid of snow, which effectively just blew it into the exact same location again, because it seems to just sort of fall in the location where we've been, you know, getting rid of it. But I feel that we are helpful people to society. Wow, this is a horrible camera angle. Try getting your camera angle in, like, the place where the snow is going.
Ooh, that's a good one. I tried to... use cheats, but it doesn't work. I think I need like a password to activate it. But I did notice that there's a cheat for no fuel. That sounds amazing.
No fuel, that's a pretty good cheat.
That's actually only three ones. There's no fuel, add fuel, and end task. That's it.
End task, that would be pretty useful.
Yeah, we could just skip to the end of the game. We could skip
every... like, there's gonna be a cutscene. Let's be honest here. There's not gonna be a cutscene. There's not I gonna be a congratulations.
Like a Blizzard quality cutscene.
Oh yeah!
that
would be so amazing. Like the animators of Blizzard have been working on all these little, like, simulation games, and with each of them, there's like a really high quality trailer where the entire budget went into, and like everything else is just like move the snow from place A to place B. Once you finish move snow, move it back to place A. Keep this up for 15 more tasks, and you will see a high-quality trailer for the next World of Warcraft expansion.
Just imagine 8 players.
This would be great.
Because you'll have like one or two vehicles which can do the task you need to do.
Well, yeah, but the other ones can help. Like, you saw what happened with the previous task. They were very helpful.
Oh, God.
I felt that you were a very helpful addition to my task doing, personally. Like, without you, I don't think I would have gotten the surprise sledge to the surprise lift.
That's a good point. That's a good point.
I have to admit, I kind of hate this.
This is kind of horrible, yeah.
This is pretty bad, but we're nearly done, theoretically. This kind of reminds me of Guild Wars 1, actually. Because that also had, like, a thing where you had to fill in percentages by going to specific parts of a snowy area. And in that game, I remember screaming at, like, the final little bits of percentages that just wouldn't go down. Oh, all the snow appeared again. That's great. Use large snowcat to groom lower part of ski. Okay. Sure.
Gar.
Yeah? Yeah, talk to me.
What are we doing?
We are lowering the front plow. We are going to groom this ski baby.
Okay. Am I doing it?
I'm honestly not sure, but I feel groomed.
I don't think we're doing it. I think we're supposed...
No, don't worry about it. We're doing it.
I don't think we're doing it.
We're ski trail grooming.
Like, this thing is definitely touching the snow, but I don't see any effect.
You might say that.
You don't even have yours lowered. You're just going to rob me.
It moved my vehicle faster, so I figured it was more efficient.
I don't.
No. We're grooming, I swear.
We have another big vehicle with another thing, don't we?
Oh, yeah, we have the red one.
What the hell is it?
It's places.
Did we detach it from both this weird thingies?
Maybe.
Okay. So I have a plan. I'm gonna try this, and if this doesn't work, I'm very tempted to just scream and not do this anymore.
Really? Wow. I'm gonna help get our little other red vehicle back into position.
Because for as good as this game is, it's not that good.
I don't know what you're talking about. Like, I feel like I'm learning a lot about snowplowing.
How do I touch? R and T and Q, I guess.
Probably. Those are pretty much the only buttons used. Although it was X for the snowplow.
No, I think that's about activating it, not about touching it.
Oh, okay.
Maybe I have to...
Okay, I got... I saved every vehicle at once, so I think you should be pretty proud of me, personally.
Oh, my God.
Like, I feel that we are saved.
If it weren't for me, you would be nowhere in the snowcat business.
That's very possible, but you live in Norway, so you kind of have an inherent advantage.
I can't attach this. I cannot attach this.
Just give me a moment. I'll be there in a sec.
Wait. I see another one.
I got to reset. Aw, yeah. Okay. Attach back plow. Oh, there's a little yellow symbol over that one. There's a little yellow dot. Hang on. Let's go there. Get it on there. Chris? Okay. Okay, Sectus.
Oh my Jesus, what are you doing?
You are going to show me some respect around here. Because I just did the thing that you and your Norwegian blood were not able to do.
Okay.
I got my little brush, and I'm gonna do some hardcore grooming right now.
You might have a future in snowcat business after all.
Damn right, I have a future in snowcat business. I live for this. I live for the grooming of snow. This is my goal forever. This is why one day I'm gonna move to Norway and drive big vehicles and give the snow a good comb over.
Gower?
Yes.
This seems similar to the snow blowing.
You could say that.
I am saying it.
Well, it's interesting though, because in this one, like, I went completely out of the bounds and the percentage symbols still went up.
Okay. I will make this more interesting.
Okay.
I will make this more interesting. You did the grooming.
I'm doing the grooming. I'm grooming as hard as I can right now.
Okay, good. You do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, come on, do it.
I'm doing it right now.
I'm not afraid of you.
I know you're not because
so
I don't...
Yeah, just do it, Gar. Come on.
I don't really know where you are right now.
I'm somewhere.
I'm pretty impressed that... Okay, no, it actually did stop going up after I went to an obscenely far away place. And now I'm stuck.
Really?
I'm no longer stuck. Don't worry about it. Oh god, I feel that the snowplow mafia is in our vicinity with its ghost cars right now because there's some weird things going on in my back mirror.
I'm finding a challenge to all of this.
Apparently you are. The challenge mostly is actually just to turn at all. Oh, well, okay. Thanks, physics. Physics helped me where I am now. I find these boundaries interesting because I don't feel they really represent where I need to be. Like, they're like, you kinda need to be here, but not really. Sexist?
Yes!
There are vehicles everywhere! Driving into walls! I feel this, you're not helping me in my best interest right now in this snow grooming business. Like, most of the cars aren't even moving, they're just kind of placed.
I'm working on it, this is difficult, okay?
Why are you not just moving every vehicle at once?
I am doing my best!
I'm sorry, I'm being mean to you. I shouldn't be so mean, and I hope you can forgive me. Though, I am starting to see your point that 8-player multiplayer for this game is just a really stupid idea. Because really the only thing they can add is this challenge that you're trying to add for me right now.
Yeah.
And the driving really only barely works, does it?
Like, it's so difficult.
Right now I'm just combing the land. Like, Spaceballs got nothing on me. When they were combing the land with their combs.
God, that was an amazing job.
Like, at least I have a vehicle. Oh no. Oh, it stopped oddly. But that's fine. I can do this even if a car is trying to eat me, because I have been in the snow grooming business for longer than you would imagine, actually. This is a problem. No, wait. The percentage is going down.
Really?
It went down to 31.0 when I started to go backwards. So you actually are adding a challenge. But now it's going back up again, even though my snow groomer is not even touching the floor.
Oh, God.
No. We got this. It's going down again, but it's going up again as well. Physics aid us in our time of need. I'm deeply impressed with anyone else who's managed to get this far into this game.
Gar.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how much
I can handle. I need you to hang on for just a little bit longer. We need to see the World of Warcraft trailer, because otherwise we're not going to be able to feel like we've been a really good success. We are the ones that need to be teaching the Snowcat business what's what with the simulator, and I think there's some Snowcat higher-ups right now looking at us and going, wow, these two know what they're doing. They only took about 2 hours to get the service supply surprise to the lift thing, and then they blew some snow into the same place again, which made everything back to normal.
I don't know. Why? What are those two timers?
Well, one timer, I think, is the amount of time we've been spending on this mission, and the other one is just like a magical timer, which just
maybe
sort of
the other time is how much time is spent actually grooming.
No, because I'm standing still and nothing's happening to it. Unless, like,
I mean, how much time has elapsed since we started grooming? Because we did start kind of late. Because
I guess. You could say that. I'm going to detach one of these things, and I hope it's the right one. There we go. Because I don't feel like this thing's really helping me very much.
I don't know what to do anymore, Gar. I don't know what to do.
Can you get in the other red vehicle and, like move around a bit, make yourself at home?
Are you telling me to actually groom?
Is there a thing with, like, a red little yellow symbol next to it?
I see one with a yellow symbol, which I tried to attach and I couldn't attach.
I need you to attach it some more. I feel that while the first time it may feel a little odd, the second time it's going to give you the things you need. You have to attach it to your back, though.
Yeah, I did try. It wouldn't attach it. It wouldn't.
Well,
I can try again. I can.
Yeah.
I can try again.
If you want, I can give you this one, and then...
Okay, yeah. I accept this challenge.
You accept this challenge of me giving you this one?
Yes.
Okay.
I accept this challenge.
That's a good thing to accept, I guess. There it is. Well, you were moving in an area that looks entirely different from mine, so I guess maybe this is going to be the thing. Come on, little snow trip.
Wow, this is so fun.
You sound like you're having fun.
I haven't had
pond like this ever.
Ever. Like, wow. Not like this. Not like this.
This snow, it's groomed. It's grooming.
Well, it's not groomed yet. That's what we're doing right now. We're doing some good grooming work.
Wow.
The grooming industry is very impressed with us right now, okay?
I don't know anymore. I just don't know.
I'm going to say just one little thing right now. And that is that I'm going to call you somewhat of a loser. Because I went
really?
To... Yeah.
How? I tried. I pressed all the buttons and I drove into it and everything.
I don't think you really, really gave it all. Because sometimes I feel like you're not really giving it all for the Snowcat business.
I have to be honest, sir. I have to be honest. I have an agenda. Like, I am all about the port, specifically in Hamburg. I don't care about Snowcat. I just want to continue my port business.
I don't really believe the words you're saying right now.
I'm sorry. I felt this way this entire time.
Are you? You're not actually lying right now. This is actually how you're feeling about it.
I love tugboats.
I know, like, I as a deeply Australian man, I know the feeling, the love you get for a good tugboat.
Cranes, did you know how satisfying it is to move a crane back and forth slowly until you line it with a container?
I actually don't, because when we played that game, I was player two, and they can't actually do that, so I kind of just rode around in my tugboat.
And then you pick up the container, and you're like, oh god! The container is in my hands, my crane hands.
The thing is, though, like, right now, what you can imagine is that the snow isn't really snow. It's a cat. And what you're doing is you're giving a tiny, tiny cat a little brushy brush. And let's be honest, we've all wanted to give a tiny little cat a little brushy brush in our lives. Because tiny cats get really cute when you try to brushy brush.
I know, it's called Snowcat. It's not actually a real cat.
That is something that I refuse to believe, because that would just destroy all my life ambitions, to be perfect.
However, if you think about port, that is actually a real port.
No, port is like a drink that people drink to get drunk, and getting drunk is like evil. Also, I may need your help a little bit, because I've gotten to a situation. Oh, no, wait, I got out. Never mind. Either way, this game's physics, I feel, are more impressive than those of port.
This is so slow.
No, we're nearly there. Like, remember the times where you and I were running through the savannah in Resident Evil 5? Like, remember those happy times when, like, back, we didn't have a comb. We had nothing to groom. And I feel that if we did, we would have gotten through that savannah in like 5 minutes. So imagine just, like, how slow this would be if we didn't have a large comb attached to our vehicles right now.
We spent more than 5 minutes on this.
You might say that because the clock says so, but in your heart, what does it really say?
My heart says port.
Your heart says port, but your mind says
actually, comb. Actually, no, I changed it. I changed my opinion. Extreme sailing. That is what I'm for. Extreme sailing.
I'll admit that I am also for extreme sailing, but that's because... there's a racing game called, like, Power Boat 2 or something like that, and that is actually, like, a really good racing game. And I'm not even kidding. It's, like, genuinely quite decent. You need to accept your responsibilities as a Snowcats runner. And you have to work before you can have a good time. Otherwise, you're not going to have the money to take over your extreme sailing business.
Okay.
Where are you going?
I'm grooming.
I can see that you're grooming. I'm just not quite sure what you're grooming right now.
I found a hidden path. I think this leads me to one of the warp pipes.
Oh, the warp pipes. Well, there's a green balloon there. So if you find a warp pipe over there, then I would like to know about it, because I would like to go to World 8 as quickly as possible.
Yeah, it's best one.
Yeah, World 8 is my favorite. But until then, I'm just gonna groom away.
No.
No?
I see an end.
You see an end? Why would there be an end to your great adventure?
I see a fence.
Oh no. Well, to be fair, fences have gotten us to great locations so far.
Well, they haven't really moved us very far. They have done great things, but...
I mean, it's all about the greatness in life, Sectus. It's about getting to the places where you need to be. Like, the most, you know? I don't know, but you...
I have done mistakes.
You've done mistakes, you say?
I've done mistakes.
I'm gonna just get into your vehicle really quickly. Oh, I see what you mean.
Oh no, I don't think I have space to like turn around and going backward is kinda slow.
I'm pretty impressed with what you've done. I briefly got into your vehicle to see what your situation was, and I feel that it is a situation where in life we've all felt that way. But not all of us feel like we should actually get in that situation. So we get out of it as quickly as possible. But you've made a pretty big hole for yourself. But that's okay, because it makes you remember the good times where not everyone had a grooming comb.
Do you remember the music? Do you remember the music in Port?
I do, music? And we both hated it. We were both quite dissatisfied with the music in that game because it was like a 5-second loop from the sounds of things.
I yearn for that music.
No, you
to
don't.
Return to my heart.
I yearn for you to continue combing our path because we're nearly done, and you made the work a lot quicker.
I'm not gonna get there in time.
I think you are, because you don't even know how slow this is.
This is slow.
Okay, I'll give you that one. I guess your trip is probably a little bit slower than mine.
Okay, don't worry, I'm good. I was able to turn around.
Wow, how?
Warp 10, engage. Make it so.
This thing's only moving at like 30 kilometers per hour. Maybe I'll just do like what you did with Mod Progress 2, where I'll have like the full version and I'll have like a highlights version. Because I feel that this right now, like I could do without this.
So like Mod Progress 2, you also wait like a year to wait until people are ready for this?
You did that with Rock of Ages, so let's be honest, I might as well do that with this as well.
But yeah, I activated Warp 10, so I am already back.
You are really fast, yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah, like I was not...
Tell I was gone?
I didn't even know you were gone. I thought you were one of these cars just standing like having your coffee break, but... No, you were
coffee, I love it.
No, you don't.
Glug, glug, glug.
Glug, glug, glug. That's the sound of coffee to my ears. Like, look at how much faster this is going with you here.
Holy shit.
You're driving backwards.
I'm trying to find like a good spot where I can do the grooming.
Your driving backwards is making the percentage go down.
That's a good point. Also, you're outside the area.
Well, you would say that, but it is actually going up while I'm here.
Really?
Yeah, it's kind of silly. We're nearly done with this, man. Just hang on for a little bit longer. And I'm sure this is the last task. Like, after this, the skiers of ski free can you chose a different car. You're not grooming. You're not grooming, Sectus.
I'll go back to grooming.
I darn right you are, because without you grooming here, then we're not gonna get this done in time for the tea party.
I have something to admit, Gar.
What?
I was lying. I don't think Blizzard made the final cutting for this.
Are you sure? Because I think they have. Because if you look at like the. Like, if you zoom in all the way on your car, you can see a little yellow warning symbol with an electricity thing on it. And as you may remember, Diablo had a spell called Chain Lightning. And with Chain Lightning, electricity came out of your hands. And I feel that electricity made it all the way to the little sign that says electricity on a little car. And, you know, that's really the only logical conclusion I can pull from this. To be honest, I mean, otherwise, why would we be doing this, you know?
Why would we be?
Exactly. Those sounds, all of them, all at the same time. So, in the end, like, if Blizzard hasn't made the cutscenes for this, then I would just be very sad. I would still keep playing, but I would be very sad. Yeah.
We're actually getting to 100%.
We made it. Use small snowcat to place snow cannon 1 of 3.
Snow cannon?
Darn right, no, snow cannon. Okay. See, you were so negative, but now there's a snow cannon.
Okay, I'm convinced. This game is awesome. Where's the snow cannon?
I need you to help me move. Oh god, my wheels are like stuck in the floor. I need you to push me. Because I seem to be stuck in the floor.
You.
Yeah, that's me. Come on, get me.
Oh, I'm just getting into position. Just getting into position.
You're getting in. Oh wow, your turning skills are beyond this world. Oh wait, maybe if I like press the magical button. Oh.
My Jesus.
Look at this movement.
What is that?
I'm bouncing.
What?
You didn't really move me very well.
You seem stuck in an odd way.
I am stuck in an odd way, which is troubling to me.
You're like anchored to that right thingy.
Yeah.
Oh,
wait. Press T to detach. Oh, hey.
Jesus Christ!
Pressing T did not actually detach it. It's still on my vehicle. Which is a bit strange. But this thing is so quick compared to the big red beast we were just driving for 5 hours.
I wish I had a snow cat.
Would be cool, wouldn't it? Would be cool if they added at least two of this for, you know, multiplayer purposes, but... You know, especially since there's apparently 3 snow cannons instead of just 1. But, you know, that'll be cheating.
So, snow cannon.
Yeah.
What's a snow cannon?
It's, well, you know a regular cannon, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, this one shoots snow.
I've been playing Assassin's Creed 4, so I know what a cannon looks like.
Okay, well, that's like step 5 already, okay. So... Step 6 is that you, instead of a cannonball, you
is
put
a
in
cannon?
A really large snowball instead.
Okay.
And with the you destroy some worlds. I'm trying to drive backwards, man. I swear I am, but it's just not letting me. Okay.
I don't see a cannon.
No, it's over here. Don't worry about it.
I clicked outside the window again.
How are you continuously clicking outside this window?
I'm rotating my camera a lot. I'm good at rotating.
I'm not even like I just hold right mouse button forever because I'm basically playing an MMO.
Yeah, but yeah, when I hold my right mouse button, like look right, and then I click on another monitor.
Why would you click on another monitor?
Because I have 2 monitors.
Well, that's your mistake. That's where you went wrong. Right. So find some cannons for me.
That's not a snow cannon.
Yeah, it is.
That's the snow cannon.
How do you not see this being the snow cannon that it truly is?
There aren't many places with stuff.
Yeah, I don't really know if this is a cannon, but there's 3 of these things here. Well, there's like one bigger one as well. But these seem to be like the only things that would move. Yeah, this is really not doing it for me. Yeah. Oh, maybe it's the thing. Yeah.
Thing?
Yeah. Maybe it's the thing, you know?
The thing.
You know the movie The Thing? And
the
then
thing.
And then in the end it just turned out to just kind of be like a bunch of garbage. Like in this game it's a reference to The Thing. Like what I'm doing right now is a reference to The Thing. I'm just continuously impressed by how great this game is.
I haven't actually watched the movie The Thing.
Same. I'm just kind of saying words.
I can't find any cannons.
I need your help right now. I've gotten myself in one of those positions again, which lead me to believe that co-op is mostly added so you can have a second person to fix the physics for you.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
No, don't be so pessimistic. We're getting there. Danger. High voltage. Okay, hey. Hi. So I was just driving along. Wow. See what...
Did you put that thing there?
It seemed like a good location at the time.
God damn it. I'm trying to get loose.
No.
It was going so well!
I'm gonna move to your vehicle for a moment. Actually, I'm gonna move to this one. So I'm gonna move to... Where am I? What is this vehicle doing here?
I was driving around.
Oh my god. Oh god.
Don't you feel the need to drive around sometimes?
No, I feel the need to play snow cannons.
Like, find a way away from this.
This is a very loud car.
I can't get this red thing is like...
Okay.
It's a trap.
I'm gonna assist this one first. Boom.
Oh, wow. Yeah, wow.
Look at that. A wheelie and everything. All thanks
it's still, to... It's still there, though, as a trap.
Don't worry about it. It's for intruders. Okay, this is, we're helping. Yeah, that... Yeah.
Co-op.
Co-op, yeah.
Although, I might be stuck now, but that's fine.
That's fine. We don't need that vehicle, but... Yeah, bye. And now, there's a couple things here which might be able to function as a snow cannon, and I'm going to try to move one of them. It might also be a lamp, but the two are pretty much interchangeable, right?
Oh yeah, you might be onto something, like, yeah.
Yeah. Are you in my car right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Because, whenever you enter the car I'm in, your nameplate just isn't actually correct at all.
Yeah. It isn't even correct on my screen as well. Like, I see my own name on another vehicle.
Nice. So, one might say that this is, like, the expected... Maybe I need to be on the other... Okay. Maybe I just should not touch this thing.
It does actually kind of look like...
It looks pretty attached, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, like, if you give me a few minutes, this car's gonna move forward, and,
I definitely can't see anything else which would be a snow cannon, though.
Well, these things look kind of, like, snowy. Like, they look like the top part of the snow cannons. But I just don't really understand how I'm supposed to... Oh, wait, there's, like, in the middle of it, there's a thingy. Don't worry, I got this.
Oh, dear Christ, you're actually right.
Yep, I know what I'm doing. I've been in the Snowcat industry.
I guess we might have knocked that one over.
Yeah.
From that I forgot the name of it. Thingy.
Sure. Yeah, that one.
The palette. Palette.
Yeah, wow, that's actually a word. I'm sometimes impressed by your wordification of things.
Yeah. No. I am so sad you figured out like this is the thing because you're actually gonna do it, aren't you?
You don't think I'm just gonna give up? Like, why would I give up on a great and noble deed?
There's many reasons.
You might say
there's
that.
There's such a huge list.
Now look, I'm getting them places. See? I may need your help again. That sounds like the sound of, yeah, I'm ready to help. Count
help
me
bank.
In. Wrong car. That's not the helping car, that's the stuck car. Yeah, this is pretty bad. I'm pretty stuck in this pallet. It would be good if, like, the reset button just worked all the time, because...
That would make the game a lot easier.
Yeah. Wow, good job.
Thanks.
I knew you had it.
So, I should just randomly ram you, right?
Yeah, that's basically what you need to do. Yeah, there we go. That was very helpful.
Need fuel.
Oh, thank you.
I thought you needed some.
I needed some fuel in my life.
I'm gonna just hump you.
Thanks. I guess I'm not really sure how to respond to that statement, but I feel like thanks is a pretty good way of starting it. Oh, that one's flying. Oh, everything's flying now.
Okay.
Okay. I got one kind of like in the location where we might be able to pick it up.
I'll try to drive away.
I'll give you a good luck wish in my
heart. Then I'm going to watch you and be sad and ask myself, what am I doing in life? What?
Yeah, I really don't see you. Well, okay then.
So, who do you think this game is targeted towards?
Oh, well, us. We're playing it for quite a while now.
That is true, but, like, there has to be other people playing it too. Like, is it targeted towards people actually doing this in real life, or people who want to do this in real life?
I guess so. I mean, is this a noble? It's a noble cause.
Like, is there a kid growing up? Wow, I want to be a snowcat driver.
Specifically, those words, yeah.
Wow.
Well, it's part of. I genuinely don't understand how we're supposed to do this.
I have an idea.
What?
There's this escape key
no,
on the keyboard.
No, I don't actually have that keyboard. I removed it from my keyboard because I feel like sometimes there's just no escape, you know?
Well, maybe you have other keys, that like Alt+F4, for instance.
Oh, wait, I found out. I figured it out.
What?
Look, it's working.
You're driving backwards.
Yeah. But I'm taking...
You drive... with an imaginary snow cannon.
Oh wait, is the snow cannon not on your screen?
I don't see a snow cannon on your
okay,
screen.
Okay, where do you see a snow cannon?
You were driving towards one for quite a while. I see only one snow cannon which is not attached to anything.
Where?
I'll drive to it.
Because I see three again, like as per usual.
That's like, a good bug.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the one, like, I'm, like, to the left of me. That's the one.
The one that fell down on the, next to the pallet.
Yeah.
Okay.
The one which looks impossible to get to.
Yeah, that's an issue I'm gonna think about after I've already started going for it.
Yeah.
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 Don't worry, though, because as a snow cat constructor,
okay, while you're doing that, I can tell a story about a stupid game.
I would like to hear this story and feel that it's not at all related to the game we're currently playing.
Have you heard of... I forgot the name of it, but there's this, like, rather popular game jam. We have to, like, create a game fairly quickly.
Yeah.
And someone, there were, like, at one time, there was a theme about, like, creating a game about escaping. Like from a prison or something.
Okay, I guess I wasn't aware of that specific one, but go on.
Yeah, and then someone made a game which was like a pretty fun puzzle game, like adventure style. Like you were stuck in a room, you had a bunch of items you can mess around with, and you had to like figure out how to escape the room.
Mm-hmm.
You want to know the solution?
Yes.
Every item does nothing. You just have to press the escape key on the keyboard, and that's the solution.
That's a pretty stupid game.
That's a pretty stupid game.
Yeah.
Like, granted, he only spent like a weekend or something on it, but it's still a pretty stupid game.
It's a pretty stupid game.
So I just wanted to spend this like minute to make fun of that one guy making a stupid game.
Yeah. Huh? Oh!
What the hell are you doing?
I needed to get this car in the location where it needed to be, and I needed to get another car to push it. And now I'm getting the snow cannon where it needs to
Holy
be.
Holy shit, this is dramatic!
It's like Die Hard, what I'm doing right now.
Yes!
Did they ever make
like a Die Hard movie based on snowcat missions? Like, this would happen.
This would happen. Like, look at this hardcore action right now. Like, there could be explosions everywhere and everyone would be like, yep.
The Mafia.
The Mafia, yeah.
You still stuck to it.
I'm pretty impressed. Oh, no, there we go. I got rid of the Mafia.
I'm tempted to drive into you, but on the other side, I'm also not tempted.
I would laugh, probably. So,
well, laughing is good.
Yeah, it's my happiness that's on the line, really. I'm not laughing.
Okay, hey, that's the path I took earlier. Wasn't
yeah,
fun?
Now there's actually...
Hey, look, I groomed it for you.
Thanks for grooming the path for me, man. This makes it a lot easier to go up, actually.
Yeah.
I really feel combed.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like my little driver man, he's like, yep, I'm driving the comb path up the snow mountain thing. And my window sometimes clips through the camera, including my entire vehicle. It's kind of worrying. I wish it didn't do that.
What did they use the snow cannon for?
Just adding more snow to the field in case there's not enough snow. Like, if there's like patches of snow that are missing.
In case someone does too much grooming?
In case someone does too much skiing on the skiing field and removes all the snow, and then you just kind of fall flat on your face, and that's kind of bad.
Do you think they ever use snow cannon to, like, shoot at the skiing people?
I think so, yeah. Okay, so that's...
Car!
Yeah.
I should have seen it coming, but when it said 1 out of 3, it did mean 1 out of 3.
Yeah, that is the words that were on the screen. Don't worry, it is actually a game, because now you have to direct me which one is actually on your screen again. After I finished humping the wall.
Oh, new mechanic.
Oh, here's the new mechanic.
Yeah, I have to go get fuel for this vehicle. I'm low on fuel.
Wow. There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's new. We haven't done that before.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
It looks exciting, right?
Yeah. So, when you got new fuel for your vehicle, I got a new challenge for you.
What?
Well, if you go to my vehicle, you can see something that's currently a little bit amiss, which you may have noticed before. It may have happened in the past. Yeah. So, yeah, how about that?
How?
It's actually pretty easy. You just kind of drive into anything and then it sort of just happens.
Shall I help you or shall you help yourself?
Both. I think it's a race, personally.
I'm in third gear. Are you?
I don't know, because, like, pushing the buttons doesn't really seem to be that effective.
Well, I'm ahead of you.
You are, but what does it really mean?
I'm best.
Are you ahead in happiness?
Yes.
Are you ahead physically?
Yes.
Are you ahead as a fluffy little man?
Yes.
Oh, well, I guess you're ahead then. But still, I still feel ahead, personally.
Oh, that's really... down road.
Wow, this man is scary. He doesn't have a face sometimes. It's a pretty good camera angle, though. Like, this is a pretty good surprise car chase that's going on my screen right now. It's like... boom. Explosions everywhere.
Fixed.
What? Oh.
Fixed.
Fixed even more.
You're fixing it. You unfixed it. You reset there.
There we go. I got the car back the way it needs to be. Just need to start moving and then we are on our way. There we go. All is well. Don't worry about it, man. We got this. Can you please move those cars out of the way? Those might be in the way. I don't know why you placed those two cars there, but I guess if you just start driving backwards with one and then just switch to the other one, it'll probably just go all the way down again.
That would be good. I would approve of that.
I think it's going.
I hate to be rude, but I'm going to go AFK for a minute.
Okay, I'll just do the snow grooming myself.
Yeah,
okay, well, that's fine. So, Sectus the Coward left us on our own ordeals, which is kind of unfortunate, because Snowcat drivers don't really get much company in the job they do. I mean, it's kind of a given. You're kind of in the truck, and there is another seat, but usually people aren't that overly interested in driving a Snowcat places, you know? And even though there is a pretty good hot air balloon over there, it just doesn't feel the same as an actual person, you know? So it's not the same as actual communication. And I'm pretty impressed that Sectus actually managed to get in the way, given what he did to get all the way down there. And actually got the vehicle stuck as well, I think. The front wheel's spinning quite vividly, and it's pretty exciting. Which is good. I'm actually gonna use one hand to open this bottle over here.
And look at this. If I could actually get some to drink out of the bottle.
Okay, there we go. It actually opened, though. Very good. Now, the problem that we're facing right now is that I don't know which one of these snow cannons is actually real. Although, I think that one wasn't there anymore previously. So, with some luck, it is actually just that one. And we can move it once I get into the right position. The problem, of course, being getting in the right position at all, because this game's controls are made by a slug. Like an actual slug, just a living, breathing slug. Like, I'm holding backwards now, but it's just not really doing anything, really. It kind of reminds me of just starting the game in general. Like, for some reason, when you try to start the game, it just does nothing for about a full minute, and then it just sort of starts. And I do mean an actual full minute. You click on the game to start it, and then it just... You don't even know it's working on anything. It just kind of goes in the background, apparently, just for a full minute. I timed it as well. It was a full minute of wasted opportunities. And I find that unfortunate, because it kind of makes me not want to play the game. But fortunately, we got multiplayer all set up, all ready to work, and ready to move our snowcats into the snowcat industry. And I just realized, actually, that, well, for one, I'm stuck again, which is pretty great. Okay, there we go. And two, I actually didn't need to open that bottle because I actually had some left in my glass. And therefore, gravy is a fine substance. Now, this snow can unfortunately doesn't need to go as far as the previous one. And Sectus is not here to add some extra challenge to the whole sensation right now, so, all's good, really. It's not really anything to worry about. There's nothing going on in this world, really. There's just nothing going on in this man's life. I guess it could be a very cleverly disguised woman. Or whichever other gender this person wishes to associate with, really. But he seems pretty dead inside, regardless of gender. And that's what truly matters. It really has no... and therefore, I feel that he's living the life that he's always wanted to lead.
Hello.
Hello. I was just telling a little story about snowcat drivers. Don't worry. It's nearly done.
Why is that one car... like that?
I'm pretty impressed, actually, because that's not even my work. That was, like, the one that went all the way forward and stuff.
Really?
Yeah, like, it went all the way down, hit that wall, and,
Wow, the one I'm in went all the way down as well.
Yeah, I was pretty impressed.
I do great work by going AFK.
Yeah, I'm actually in somewhat of a pickle, because the moment I got to the yellow dot on the map, it actually just, oh no, wait, I think I got it this time.
You're not carrying a cannon.
Not anymore, I placed it in the right location.
So aren't you finished?
I need one more.
Oh.
I only did two so far, and there's still a third one.
Yeah.
I didn't even really need to guess which cannon was actually the real one either, because it just magically appeared back in the same location as the previous one, so... All in all, like, your presence really isn't very required.
Are you saying I am allowed to quit this madness?
Never! We still have so many things to do before we can call this a safe skiing location.
How many tasks do you think there is?
I don't know, we're at four now.
Should I go look up GameFox for this?
Yes.
Shall I?
Yes. I feel like probably not GameFox, because I kind of doubt anyone wrote an article for this there. Just use Google.
Snowcat.
Yeah, you could actually, yeah, just use GameFAQs. Maybe use, like, the Gamers Gate website where we bought this.
Answers.
Okay.
My serial doesn't work. Please help. No one answered him.
Yeah, that's because our serial worked.
He even listed the serial in the question.
Maybe that's why it didn't work.
Here's my key. You can even try it out.
I feel that there is...
Oh, yeah, we're great. Thanks.
I feel that that is a flawed way of asking your question.
Yeah.
For some reason. But you know, maybe there's other people on the internet that have an answer to your question.
There's airport simulator?
That doesn't sound like anything we want to touch.
Sure.
Okay, let's do it. Maybe it's as riveting as this.
Okay, let's see.
I'm glad we're never actually going over the 30 kilometers per hour speed limit, because otherwise I would feel like I'm in danger.
Me too. You know, it's surprisingly difficult to find any info on this.
It's weird, isn't it? It's like not many people play Snowcat Simulator 2011 in multiplayer mode.
Yeah. They're really missing out.
They're really missing out, I feel, because I've never had an experience quite like this. And I've played a lot of games. You can call me a gamer, actually. That's how many games I've played.
Interesting.
You sound interested in my stories.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I can't find an info.
I'm pretty impressed by the steering wheel as well, because he doesn't even move the steering wheel. He just holds it with his hands. He just moves the car by sheer force of will.
Oh god, oh god.
Well,
we're still playing this.
No, we're not.
Oh, you have to drive it to different locations?
This is the third one, and we're moving it all the way up the top of the mountain.
Oh, I didn't groove this... groom this pathway.
You didn't make this area very groovy, and I find it kind of affecting my jive. And it's kind of hard to do this job with a low amount of jive, I feel.
I can understand that.
Yeah. If you want, though, I think there's still, like, the grooming apparatus on one of the red vehicles. We might be able to use to groom this path for later purposes.
No, I sold them.
You what? Oh, you sold them?
I wanted to buy another crane in Hamburg.
I can see that, but you really won't even get close, because cranes were like 2/3 of the money you get in that game. Oh, what the? Why didn't it get off? God, press T to detach. Use large snowcat to groom. But how are we going to do it if you sold them?
Well, that's too bad, isn't it?
Well... Sectus.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. That's like the ski jump area. How do we get there? I didn't even know we could get there. Let's try going over there.
There would be a yellow icon.
There is a yellow icon. It's like over there, like in the area where you like do the ski jumps. But how do you actually physically get there?
Yeah, I see it now.
I kind of want to physically go there, because I feel like that place could be...
This is motivating me slightly.
Yeah, you feel slightly motivated right now, right?
Yeah, slightly.
Yeah.
Like, wow.
I still can't move half the time, but that's okay. I don't really need to move.
Don't need movement.
Yeah. I put up my great groomer, and now I'm going to do this turn over here. I wish we could just do everything with the orange car, that when you take a turn, you either take it really quickly or you're just on your side. Like, I thought that was a pretty good mechanic.
Sounds like a pretty good mechanic.
Yeah. Like, it seems that this place is pretty blocked off, but maybe we just never explored enough. Oh, man.
Pro tip, never drive close to any wall ever.
Yeah, that's actually quite tricky, because the walls are everywhere. Oh. The magical mountain is only letting Norwegians pass.
Indeed.
What is that banner?
Yeah, you know what? I have no idea how to get there.
Yeah. Unless we can go through here, maybe. Is this a path that a car can take?
Or... Okay, I may have found a path.
It's not
very exciting, you just like go... No, there's an invisible wall here!
I think I found a path.
Really?
Yeah. The problem is I have to do a turn next to a wall. And you can probably kind of imagine how good this is going.
You did find a path. I'm kind of far away.
Oh god, please just friggin' move.
Da, 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 da.
Okay. We're almost there. We can do this little car. Oh yeah. This little car and me are going places.
Gar.
Yar.
How much time have we spent on this?
I don't really wish to know the answer to that question. I feel that would demotivate me to do many things in life.
I think we actually spent less time to run through all of Africa.
Oh yeah, definitely.
All of it.
Yeah. Holy crap, look at that percentage though. Do you see that? Right.
Yeah, that's good, man. Yeah, wow.
You sound impressed by the percentage.
Holy shit, this is like changing my opinion so much about this game. Like, wow, this
your
game
opinion
is amazement.
Sounds entirely amazed right now. You sound amazed.
Ja,
das stimmt.
Das stimmt.
Mhm.
Snowkit meow.
Exactly. That's how I feel about it right now.
Grum grum.
Grum grum.
Deutsch.
That's German for German.
Yeah.
We're already at 14% and you're not even here yet. Like, look at how good this is going.
Can you jump?
That was really the only thing that made me excited about this. But my car really wants to jump, as you can see. But the game's not.
I'm still trying to imagine 8 people playing this.
I really would feel sorry for all 8 of them. Even though, like, I am a big supplier of the Snowcat industry, of course. Of a supplier of motivation in the tasks that are done in this very proud job, I feel.
Grooming the scale jump, oh yeah!
Okay, I may need you to push me.
Grooming, grooming.
Oh no.
Did I help?
No. I was trying to get further up the thing, but instead I just... I really, really, really hate the whole mechanic about having to wait 5 friggin' minutes before your car actually starts moving again. It's not even moving anymore.
Sucker.
There we go.
Oh, look at me. Wow, I'm racing downhill. Oh, yeah.
Juan, what's your speed? It must be like 500 right now.
32. Oh, yeah.
How is that even possible when you're going downhill? We went the same speed uphill. I feel that this is not a very realistic simulator. I'm just trying to go downhill, but... half the time, my car doesn't either drive or steer, and I find this troubling. I feel troubled, Sectus.
I guess I'll have to do all the grooming myself.
I guess you do. Oh man, we're going. We're going. We're going. We're not going.
Yeah, ditto.
That was a thrill ride of excitement.
Yeah, wow.
You could hear my screams of terror for the supersonic speed I was driving at, man.
I imagine people having this job in real life sound exactly the same.
So what's your average day like, Joe? Well, Steve... first I get in my Snowcat, then I drive with the speed of the wind.
The highlight of this, yeah, was grooming the ski jump.
The ski jump was properly groomed at the end of the day.
Yeah.
But then I fell. I fell over with me lovely Betty. And now I'm just not able to move anymore, you get me?
First Betty, now Betty.
First Betty, now Betty. I call all my snow cats the same so I won't forget any of the names. But I honor them the same way. But one of my snow cats just fell over like it just didn't even care anymore, man. And since then it just hasn't felt the same. But then, my good friend Steven came over to me and pushed me snow cat. Steven the Raphael pushed me into the right direction once more. And since then, I knew what to do with my life. I knew that snow cat business plowing grooming was the thing I always wanted to do. But fuck, they're slow. Jeez. Okay, we got something going again.
Oh, God.
I have had experiences.
Oh, God.
In my life. Which I will admit were better than what we're doing here.
Oh, God.
One of them is simply hearing you say that over and over. In that exact voice. But we're doing a pretty good job at grooming, though.
Oh, yeah.
You sound pretty impressed by our grooming job.
Oh, yeah, groom, yeah.
Groom. That's groom, how we clean groom, the room. Groom. I'm gonna do a ski jump.
Good luck, man. Thank good
you.
Luck.
Thank you, man.
I miss Journey Down.
I miss Journey Down too, actually, and I wish episode 2 would come out.
I think Journey Down was a better Snowcat simulator than this.
I also think Journey Down was a better Snowcat simulator than this. I also wish they would add a little bit more news posts as to where it is right now. Because I haven't heard from them in a while now. Wow.
We could just play the originals.
Yeah, but it's not the same.
Imagine the voices in our heads.
That doesn't really work, though. We're not that good at imagining the Jamaican voices that game uses.
We're so close.
We are so close.
So close.
God, I wish I wasn't driving backwards right now. We'd be even closer.
God damn you. Holy shit.
Use small snow cat to groom. That's different.
Yeah, that means only one of us can do it.
Don't worry, we got this.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
No.
Please, indulge me in my simple needs.
Why?
I don't really know, but something compels me to just keep doing this.
Is this the part of you who just want to go play more World of Warcraft?
Yeah, and I never really got really into World of Warcraft either, so I guess that part of me is like really, like, pretty much never really there. Except for times like this, you know? You know?
No.
You know?
No.
You know?
No.
You know?
No.
Well, you say that, but, you know?
No.
Well, okay, but, you know.
I don't know anymore.
I think that the more we do this, I feel that we're bonding. Like, we haven't really fought as much as we have lately.
Well, I mean, I will give you that. Like, we bonded in special ways whenever I try to help you.
Yeah.
That was bonding.
I flew places.
Yeah.
I just thought to myself, the highlight video should just be like 1 minute long, which is just like the flying parts. And then a link to like, what's the full video here? And it's like 4 hours long.
I was just going, ugh.
Oh, God, that'd be great. Because I will just upload this as a single video as well.
Oh yeah, that I would approve of. That I would approve of.
Yeah. Like, I'll just upload the flag as a trailer, maybe with like really exciting music in the background as well.
Do you think I would have time to go prepare food while you groom the cableway? Because I'm getting kind of hungry.
You might as well. Let's be honest. We are not really doing anything worthwhile right now.
Oh, God.
Just make like a delicious buffet for like 10 people. I think you'll probably have time for that.
Okay, I will BRB.
Okay. Very good. Oh, damn. Come on. Cute. Okay, the groomer is in place. We got something going on. We are ready to move. What? It came off. What are you doing, little groomer? Are you kidding me? Oh god, this is gonna take forever. If it just randomly comes off, that's not good. Oh, I guess the red dot's there to like show your alignment to it, but god, that's awful. Come on, turn slightly more. Just need you to get in the right location.
Okay, I'm back.
Wow, that was really quick.
I'm good at making fruit.
Apparently? Question mark?
I turned the oven on.
Alright. Oh, yeah, I guess you need to like do that for some food stuff.
So how's the grooming going?
It's going pretty well. Like the apparatus just sort of came off by itself.
Oh, do you need me to push you again?
No, not yet.
Shall I push you?
Not right now. Not right now, thank you very much.
Do you think like people with this job do that too? Just have some fun?
I'm pretty sure they do. Like, I used to work in a computer store, and every now and then I would hear stories of like the olden days of like telecom and stuff. And they drove around these little vans, and basically what they would do is that one person would stop like in front of a red light, because you know you have to stop there, and then the person who was driving behind them would just kind of push them forward slightly. Like, really slowly, but, like, enough to get scared. And I'm pretty sure that people in the Snowcat business would probably do the same thing. Like, one would just drive nearly over the edge. And then the other one would help them by ending it all forever.
Also, I just imagine this is... Like, what we've done, like we have groomed stuff, we have groomed the ski jump, for instance, and let's say, like, later they're gonna do ski jumps. Now look at this ski jump.
Well, I'll admit that there's not much snow left on the ski jump.
There's a huge patch in the middle still there, the snow cat is also just way up there.
Don't worry, we cleared it 100%, the little counter said so. And if the counter says so, then I think we did pretty well. I would also like you to join my vehicle if you haven't already. Because there's some pretty good looking lines over here.
What?
No, like there's one green one and a yellow one.
Also, there's also weird lines to your right where we've been driving before, I guess. It just looks weird.
Huh. There you go. I'm going to turn the lights on. It's kind of getting...
Why is there both a green and a yellow?
I don't know. I'm going over the green one. It's a lot bigger. Maybe the yellow one is like it's like tournament edition, because there's like poles in the way of everywhere. And this is like scrub mode, like easy mode.
I don't think I want to deal with tournament edition.
Tournament edition looks pretty hard, but I think on the way down I might do tournament edition. Because I feel like I'm ready for it, you know? Like, I feel like I've been in the Snowcat business long enough to be able to undertake such a difficult challenge. Don't you agree? Yeah, that sounds like a green to me. What kind of food are you making?
I am just making a pizza.
Okay, that's
I don't have energy to make anything complex.
Tell me more.
What kind of pizza? It's got cheese
on it. Why? Just make a pizza without cheese over it. Jeez.
It's got two types of cheese on it.
That's... Now you're just being silly.
And it's got this green stuff, which I'm not sure what it is.
Like, I gave you all of these tips on buying cheese as well, and you didn't want any of those.
I wanted all the salmiak in the world, and you linked me to cheese, which is 600 years old.
Yeah, but to be fair, it's pretty good looking cheese. It was red, and red cheese is pretty good. Proper Dutch cheese is in a red package. Gotta have some proper Dutch cheese once in your life, because then you'll know the foulness that I have to live with every day when people say, hey, you want this thing? It has cheese in it, though. Exactly, that's the sound I would make. And then
you could be a rebel, just drive forward.
I'm driving forward. Oh, like that. No. I've seen what's over there, and quite frankly, it's like less than nothing, so I might as well just go back down again.
I just realized.
What?
It's becoming dark in the game.
Yeah, it is. Like, it is actually. That's why I turned the lights on. If you look like
this much time.
If you look like north, I guess, and like kind of look up, it actually looks quite nice, like the mountains and the stars and stuff.
Yeah.
Looks quite decent.
So, are we paid for working overtime?
Oh, no. You don't get paid for the snowcat industry. You do this as a hobby. Like, this is like a project of passion right here.
Oh, God.
I know. That's what they say when they're driving the snowcats. Like, they can defy physics with this vehicle. You don't get paid for that. You get paid in respect.
Yeah.
I feel respected right now for what I'm doing here, because I can't do this in real life.
I have no words.
For one, there's the magic mountain. The magic mountain doesn't obey the rules of life. The magic mountain
is true. Like, it is both flat and endlessly high.
Yeah, and like, how many mountains in the reals do you have like that? Like the Netherlands. I'm in the Netherlands right now. We don't know what a mountain is.
Point.
Yeah.
Well, you don't even know what licorice is when you link me to cheese.
Like, when someone says mountain, I'm like, what? Mountain? What? And, like, even if they pronounce it properly, I'm like, what? Mountain? What is a mountain? And they explain it to me, and then I say, I don't understand. Because Dutch people only live in two dimensions, which is not vertical.
I also want to point out, like, if you look to your left, the green path.
Yeah.
The swirly twirly.
The swirly twirly. Yes. What about
Okay, yeah, that's it.
I think you might notice that driving forward in this game is, pardon my language, fucking impossible. Like, driving in a straight line is the hardest thing, because it just automatically swerves. So, pardon for the swirly twirly, but I'm just gonna take the path that my vehicle chooses, not so much the one which I want to take.
Okay, so I just want to point out, you've now gone all the way up, all the way down,
not even
halfway done
yep.
yet.
You might say that.
I am saying it. I am.
But, like, as you can see, the percentage was still going up for a while. After
it still isn't at 50%.
You say that like you mean it.
I am saying it. I'm saying it right now.
You might be, but sometimes worms just deflect off of me when you say them, because I don't feel...
But also, because of the swirly twirly, you won't get an equal amount of percentage going up and down again.
Well, I will actually, because I might as well just take the exact same path and the game will still just acknowledge it as, like, good enough. Because this game's pretty good at simulating, like, I could probably actually just go in the middle here, and the game wouldn't really care.
Yeah, you're actually correct.
Okay. It's still just going up.
Yeah, you're actually correct, yeah. So what do those lines even mean?
Yeah, why are there even two separate ones? Maybe this was like a test to see if they could add two separate lines.
Why do they even need a snow-groomed, like, below the left? Why?
Because when someone's skiing there and they're doing a slalom around the poles of the ski lift.
Why the hell would they do that?
Because skiers are insane. You have to realize this. As a Norwegian person who has, like, mountains and stuff in their country, you should know that people who are on skis are kind of dumb. Like, they're not on snowboards, which are definitely the safer option. And the more fun option, in my humble opinion. And my opinion's pretty humble, I think. And the swirly twirl. Like, a real skier would just go in one of these vehicles. If they really want to feel safe. But no, yeah. They go on skis, they break all of their legs, all of them. And then they just leave again. And then a year later, they're like, hey, let's do that again. That was pretty fun. Whereas a snowboarder, they're like, they fall down and they're like, well, that's not too bad because I still have both of my legs.
I just broke both arms, but that's fine.
Yeah, but I don't need my arms to do my job. Like, I can just put one leg on the steering wheel and I can put the other one on the gas pedal of my snowcat, which is primarily my job. My job is living. I choose the life that I lead.
And snowcat is practically a snowboard anyway.
Yeah, I mean, they both have the word snow in it, whereas skis just have the word ski in it, unless you're on a water ski, which has water in it, which is already pretty close to snow, but it's not quite the same as a snowboard. You know? You get me? You feel me? Brother?
Yeah, I am picking up on what you're throwing down.
Yeah, I'm throwing down some mad lyrics right now, and you are catching them like the bombs.
I need to, like, converse a little bit with my oven, so I'll be a bit.
Okay, ovens are nice conversational partners, I feel. Because an oven really truly understands sometimes. Because you talk to an oven and you say, like, hey, Mr. Oven, I'm feeling a little hungry. I'm feeling a little squashed right now. And I could use some fine nourishment in my life. And the oven will say, like, yeah. I can deal with this, yo. Hot ziggity. And then the oven brings you the gift of warm food. And warm food is pretty important for a person, because without warm food, you're not going to get very far. You're not going to get to the places where you need to be. And that's a shame, you know? It's a shame, because sometimes it's simply a requirement that you get where you need to be, and without an oven, you might not be able to reach those places up top. You might be able to do it sorta with a microwave, but it's just not the same thing. It's not the same level of crunchiness and warm delight that you would get out of an oven. And because of that, like, it's just a better idea, really, to just go for an oven, because I feel like you're really missing out with just a microwave. And I'm talking to you right now, Roger. That's right. I know that you're watching this video right now. You've been postponing making dinner for the last 2 hours because you were looking at this video and going, oh, this is pretty fun. Oh, it's only a few more minutes. I might as well keep watching. But no, you need to get out of there. You need to get a new oven and you need to make some delicious handmade bread. Because the handmade bread is really gonna do you a favor later in life. If you know how to make some good handmade bread,
I like bread.
Are gonna make some good friends. Hey, I was just talking to Roger. Like, I talk to Roger when you're not here because, well, at least then I have someone to talk to, you know? But I was just telling Roger that, like, if you learn how to make handmade bread, then you're probably gonna get ahead in life, let's be honest.
Wouldn't Roger.
Yeah, Roger. The parrot, you know?
Is that the guy driving that one car without a person in it?
Sure, yeah, that could be the one. Roger.
Is this another thing, like everybody in the snowcat business, that you just go see a therapist?
Well, it's actually more that everyone in the snowcat business is a ghost. They're not actually...
they don't actually exist.
They're not actually real people. These cars pretty much drive themselves. They're like the drones that Amazon is planning on sending out to send packages, and then people hear the word drone and think of killing machines, and they're like, oh, I'm gonna steal it. And then put guns on it and kill people, and then Amazon's like, well, I'd rather you didn't. So Roger is basically a drone out to kill people. My percentage didn't go up very high this time. I'm kind of close, yeah. Like, I feel like I am doing the grooming industry a pretty good favor right now.
I would, in fact, agree.
You would agree with me?
Oh, good point.
How long have we been recording? Oh my god.
Oh, Jesus.
Actually, what time is it? Because it's too dark in my room at this point to see my clock.
And it's quarter to ten.
Oh. That's interesting, because if it is indeed a quarter to ten, then does that mean we're recording for like 2 hours? Oh no.
It feels longer.
No, 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 no.
Oh my Jesus, you're 97%!
You are not doing this to me now. You are not putting me in this position, game.
I don't... Why is this prop car stuck there, Cliff? What are you doing?
God, why?
We're all here.
Which car was stuck on the cliff?
I don't know, some random orange car, brown car, whatever.
Oh, this one's not stuck on the cliff. I'm gonna blame the other orange car on you, because you made both of them go down a cliff yourself.
Well, they weren't... neither were stuck, though. I did fix the other one.
In fact, I'm just gonna say that every car... Pretty much every car's placement is you adding a challenge.
Okay, yeah, that might have happened. That might have happened.
That did happen.
Maybe.
This is why I need the siren. Oh god, that's so bright. We have lost it. We're actually just gone insane because of this nonsense.
Now we're finally getting it.
Yeah.
Now we're finally understanding how to play this game.
Yeah, insane.
Yes, this is the state of mind you need to properly enjoy this game.
If you zoom all the way in, you can see a pretty good camera angle with this vehicle. Like, my driver doesn't seem to have legs, which kind of bothers me. Oh, no, wait, I think it does.
God, that's only clipping.
It's a lot of clipping. But we're nearly up there. Like, these interesting things. Oh, God. I'm out of control, Steven. I'm out of control.
Steven?
Yeah, it's even
Who's
Steven.
Steven?
Even Steven. He's the one that knows how to drive cars.
Steven and Roger?
Steven and Roger. There's a lot of people on this place, you know? There's
okay,
a lot.
Okay, I believe you.
There's a lot of lifts going up and down, and you need to have the qualified people for it.
See, fixed.
There you go. Sorry about that car hitting you.
Whoa!
Well, see, it worked, see? And it's driving off on its own.
Okay, so I'll just make this car go down by itself.
Yeah. Good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's just give it a somewhat okay path.
Maybe not one with poles everywhere. That would be a good place to start.
Like this. This would probably work.
Yeah, I would say so. You're still in the car on my screen, but I guess you're in my car now.
I changed your car, not in the car.
Okay. This car is very quiet compared to the big one, and it's kind of making me feel lonely. Oh, hey. Use snowblower to... Hey, that's the one we're making go down. V, V, V. V, V, V. V, V. Oh. Oh, that's the brown car you meant. Yeah, not really sure what happened to that one. Okay, man. The road around the garage is our life.
Is this a thing I'm just gonna assume, like, no matter how horrible the game is, whatever we're gonna play for hours?
Yeah, basically. We need to get the full experience, and this is really the only way of doing it.
I wonder, have any people ever actually beat this game?
Well, that's why there's no guides. Everyone just stopped. I don't think we can save, so we just gotta keep going. I need you to get here with an orange car, though.
At least... Port Simulator to Hamburg, it had several reviews on Gamerscape. This game had nothing.
Well, no one really knows the excitement of handling a snowcat. Because none of them exist. Eventually, when maybe the people that have beaten this game just weren't actually enough of a physical presence in our universe to make a review. Like, they tried to type, but then they realized their hands were just going through the keyboard because they've been dead for so long. Have you ever considered that, Mr. Man?
No, actually no.
There you go. My car's moving at 15 kilometers per hour.
I'm on 13 right now.
14, actually. I was lying. I'm sorry.
Whoa! What the Jesus
I see.
What the hell's going on?
I just saw your nameplate fly away into the distance. What did you do?
I pressed button on the keyboard. Oh my Jesus!
Whoa! It's happening to me as well! What is going on? What is the one button?
I think that's supposed to just be first gear, but why does it...
Why does it make you fly backwards like that, though?
Wow.
Well, I'm back on 14 kilometers per hour, but... Oh, I'm at 90!
Well, I have an idea on how I'm gonna do this.
Whoa! Man, this is the sequel to Big Rigs. Driving backwards is much faster than driving forwards. I understand this game now. I don't understand this game. I don't understand how it sometimes sends you to 90. It doesn't always do it. But I'm gonna try to get on this straight path over here.
Sometimes it stops, which makes me sad.
Yeah. It's like you suddenly just hit something or something, but I don't know what though.
Whoa!
I genuinely don't understand how something like this is possible in any, like, programming sense.
Yeah.
Like, how do you even make this? like sometimes you're going to first gear, other times you're going 90 kilometers per hour backwards.
Yeah.
Like, maybe it's some weird underflow thing or something, I guess, but...
Maybe.
God, the things you figure out as you play this game, it's life-changing, I feel.
I don't find this reliable, too, though. Like, most of the time, it doesn't actually go into super mode. It makes me sad.
Yeah. When you have the snow thing turned on, it seems to happen more frequently than when you don't, though.
Yeah.
Because when you don't have it turned on, it just seems to work fine. Like, I think maybe you have to already be moving at a certain speed or something.
Yeah, I think that's right.
God, this is going in the trailer. The trailer, like, there's enough good moments to add to fill a minute, at least.
Yeah, and it would make... Like, it should convince people, wow, the full thing must be amazing!
Yeah, and then it's just this. Oh god, I need to find some appropriate music, though. For the trailer.
You can use the music from this game?
It's not really exciting music.
What about the Street Fighter win music?
That will get copyrighted, which is the problem.
Yeah.
For some
Would
reason,
you pitch it up or down?
No. Because of every possible reason anyone can think of in the next 30 seconds. No.
Okay, I am sorry, but I think my food is done now, so I'll have to...
That's okay. I'll just continue this voyage until you come back.
Okay, I'll be happy.
If I'm suddenly not in the server anymore, either I beat the game or I gave up.
Well, I'll be back quickly anyway.
Okay, bye. And now I am back on my own. Driving the path around the garage from the moment of my first life until now, figuring out magical ways of making my car move faster sometimes. Only sometimes. It doesn't work all the time for some reason. Maybe if I've just only, like, it only works if you've been driving for a while. That's still a bit strange though, but it's something I am willing to accept as a possible reason. Also, the percentage thing goes up quicker sometimes than others. Maybe it does actually depend on how much snow I'm actually removing. I don't know. Let's go back again. Oh, it stopped working entirely now. That's very unfortunate, because that was the most fun part of this. And let's be honest, having the most fun part of this removed is kind of a big deal. At least I can just kind of go around the lines as well, and that makes it go pretty quick. Because the person who drew these lines was probably insane. They were pretty generous when it came to drawing those lines. I'm pretty much just putting more snow on the track now. And, yeah, it's kind of unfortunate, really. But we're nearly there. We're nearly done. We're nearly done with our little snow-removing voyage. And then the people can drive over the road safely again. And, yeah, everyone will be pretty happy, but pretty stoked, I'd say. Maybe that little car that I moved, like, hours ago is going to be an integral part of our story, and God knows where it is now. I hope not. That'd be sad, but we'll see, I guess. Use large snow... jeez, this just keeps going. Where's the one with the grooming device? There it is. Oh. All right, I'm going that direction. Maybe Sectus' vehicle is closer to... yeah, this is a bit better, I think. Because the ski trail is over here. It worries me that it says 1 out of 2. Because it means that after the first one, I'm gonna do another one. And that is a little bit disconcerting, to be honest. I do wonder how many tasks there are, though. Because it's really only so much grooming you can do until you've gotten rid of the entire ski track, really. Press X to activate. I wonder if this thing also has one of those magical abilities to start flying out of nowhere. I guess we'll find out shortly. How quick is the percentage on this thing? Wow. That's not bad. This won't take too long, I think. Well, it's trying when you hit one on it. Like, it's considering doing some magical backflipping moves, but then it's just kind of like, no, I'm being stopped by my snow groom. Like, it just... Oh, now it's just driving forward on its own. That's pretty impressive. Like, I'm not actually pressing forward right now.
Hello. Like,
hey. That was quick.
You didn't give up.
What? No. You're still here. You're here again. That was actually really quick.
Hmm?
You're really quick back.
Yeah. I got the food now.
Oh, right. So you're just going to eat it at the computer, I guess.
Yeah.
Can you get the snow groomer over here?
The what now?
The red one.
Let's see.
I need it at the skiing place.
You know, this game actually works pretty well for like eating and playing at the same time.
Yeah, you really only need one hand.
Yeah.
I've actually been like removing the caps off of this bottle to like have a drink every now and then. Oh. This vehicle's not as good because it doesn't go into turbo mode very well. Although I did manage to get it driving forward without me pressing forward for a really long time uphill. So that's kind of impressive.
Impressive.
Yeah, I feel pretty impressed. Like, now it just keeps driving backwards even though I'm holding forward, so I'm pretty impressed by that as well.
This car is really far away.
Mm. That's why I chose this one, because you were AFK anyway, so I could let you do that.
Oh.
I've been holding forward for a while, it just keeps going backwards every now and then, and I find that impressive. Does this game accidentally have, like, gamepad controls and that my gamepad's just covered by something? Oh, no, wait, it's going for it now. Yeah, I'm stopping for accidental gamepad controls.
I already tried using the gamepad and did
nothing. Yeah, I know, but I figured I'd ask it again.
Will we actually reach a full day-night cycle in this game?
Maybe. That'll be pretty exciting. I mean, you have your Dragon's Dogma day-night cycles, and I think this one's about as good.
I like that video.
Hmm. Me too, actually. That's some nice editing.
Yeah.
It wasn't very obvious that sometimes there would be people that were walking back and forth as well. Mm-hmm. It's like you chose some very specific locations where people don't walk very often.
Yeah.
And I think that was a pretty good idea. Good editing choice.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Thanks.
You're welcome. My car just stopped and it's just dead in its tracks for a moment.
Mm. Good choice.
Thanks. It's not really a response I was expecting, so thanks for giving me the old 1-2.
3-4.
For a moment, I thought I saw you driving, like, really fast next to me, and then it turned out to be a ski lift. It was a ski lift, Sectus.
This is a sign. We've played this for too long.
No. We're nearly done.
This and the fact that you're talking to a ghost called Roger.
No, his name is Steven, you insensitive jerk.
Why did you say Roger at one point?
What are you talking about? We never mentioned anyone named Roger.
Oh, fuck.
God. My car's stuck again. It's so annoying. Like, this is probably the worst car anyone's ever added to anything in like, gaming history. Like, people were pretty negative about the driving sections that were added in some first-person shooters or third-person shooters. But I personally feel that this entire experience is a lot worse. That whenever I have to go into this car and do anything with it, which is usually grooming because it's the only thing this car seems to be able to do. Ooh, this is gonna look really nice though. Like, this is gonna be like the first proper grooming job we've ever done anywhere.
Yeah, wow, I'm feeling so proud.
You sound proud. You're like ski free. That doesn't even make sense, but it's true.
Me?
You? What?
I don't know, shut up.
Why did you just say me randomly?
Well, you called me ski free, and that's me.
That's did you say mean or just me?
Me.
Okay. I'm just verifying, you know, because these are important distinctions to make.
Yeah.
You see how I'm driving forward?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, me too. I've been holding left for a while now. Like, you probably won't even be able to guess how long, because time doesn't pass that slowly. Oh man, look at that beautiful turn. I'm actually running out of gas. Like, I'm on 81 liters with this thing right now. 80 now. Would be a shame if all of our cars suddenly stopped moving. Our percentage doesn't go up very fast anymore. What?
Fuel.
Yeah.
How's your fuel?
It's 72, it's in the red.
It's 64 for me.
I'm doing some good grooming. I'm glad the game accepts my odd grooming techniques. Because getting those last percentages does seem to be pretty tricky.
You know what I could do?
What?
Is that I actually try to figure out how you cheat in this game.
I would like that, personally. I think that would improve our gameplay experience.
Okay.
Just figure it out, and I'll just keep on grooming.
Okay, I'll try to figure it out.
Okay. I genuinely have no idea what part I still have to groom on this mountain, because I got nearly all of it. Maybe I need to hit like the super right side over here. God, now it's reminding me of Guild Wars. Like, getting those last couple of percentages. And it's not listening to me holding the left mouse button anymore anyway, because I'm too close to the wall, which is good. Good game. Please turn left. Please, please, please just turn left. That's all I'm asking here. I swear to God. You useless machine. Oh my God. I'm just going to turn it off and turn back. Oh God. Please. Well, the music's getting pretty funky now, though. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Look at those percentages going up. Sometimes. Sometimes, just gotta stay a little bit further away from the wall, I think. No, not that far. Not that far! This stupid machine, I need you to be a little bit better. 81. 8.6. 8.8. No, please. 99.9. Are you kidding me? Okay, there we go. Oh, even though it said one of two, I only needed one. Okay. Fair enough. I'm gonna make you go back up again. Back down again, rather. Deactivate. Deactivate. Why is it not deactivating anymore? Okay, well, fair enough then. I guess we're gonna just get rid of all the snow everywhere because we can't actually deactivate this. Like V or something. It's snowing really badly right now. Check this.
I don't think anyone besides us ever played it. I'm googling like a crazy person. I find nothing. I find nothing.
That's pretty good. I mean, not many games you can say that we were really like the first people to get to a certain point in this game. But I think we can safely say that we have reached unreached territories by man.
I think that's true.
I don't think even the people that developed this game got this far.
Yeah.
They put in the mission and they were like, well, hope this works.
Wow, the current objective sounds like dramatic.
Yeah, you can really help me with this one, I think, because I think we don't really need a tow truck. You can probably just get one of those orange trucks and just push it away.
Oh, God.
I think that should be the next challenge. But first I'm going to the little gasoline icon over there. Also, it's so snowy that I can barely see anything. It's making me feel really scared of our situation. And you're just kind of hugging a wall right now. Which I also find a bit worrying, but I guess that's just where your mind has gone at this point. That and food. Mostly food, I guess.
It's the only place I find comfort.
Just against a large post.
Yes.
Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, we have been at this for a while. It's a good thing I tested sound.
Okay. I found one mention. There's this weird site in another language.
Is it in German? Because that would be good.
No, it's not in German. There's something
that's a problem.
Called Augrar Simulator 2011, and it mentions cheats like cheating fill, cheating login, cheating no fill, cheating refill, but it doesn't mention how you use them.
Ah, damn.
It just mentions the commands, I guess.
Agrar might be like Agricultural Simulator 2011, I guess.
Yeah, probably.
I swear to jeebies, this is the stupidest area anyone has ever decided to put a small post on the floor, which can be easily hit by someone, and now I'm just stuck on something. And I don't know why. I need your help.
Give me a couple of seconds.
I might actually not need your help. There's like a vehicle right there. Yeah, how can you use this one? Oh, my fuel's running really low on this one. Okay, that should get it unstuck. I might as well refuel this thing while I'm at it, so we don't need to worry about that anymore. Move. There you go. Okay, I guess you're not gonna get refueled then. Fine, whatever. Just stay there forever. What do I care? Sectus?
Yeah?
Oh, wait, I thought... Wait.
What?
You're in the vehicle that we need to move.
Help?
Yeah.
Can I just move it? Hey, I can just move it.
Cool.
Why don't I just drive?
Because it was stuck.
Oh!
I'm gonna get in that.
Where do we need to go?
I think you know where we need to go.
There's two yellow dots, I'm confused.
Get the closest one first, because that's probably gonna be like the towing thing.
Okay.
The lights turn on.
Is this a new vehicle? Did we just get a second Snowcat?
No.
Oh.
This is just another orange truck that's been trapped.
No, I mean the one I'm driving.
No, that's just the one that I was driving until it got stuck, and then I went into a different one.
Oh, so where? I'm really confused.
Oh my god. There's like a yellow dot right next to me right now.
Yeah? What you standing on?
Go there.
Okay, can you move?
Nope, because I'm stuck.
Okay.
That's why I'm getting a different truck right now, which is like in the mountain lands for some reason. To get our original truck unstuck on the thing you need to pick up. This is a good game. Please don't. What is even going on?
What?
Just go to the vehicle that I'm in right now and just question reality for a moment. Like, why? Why is this a thing? Whatever, I'm just gonna go on.
Very good, very good.
This one, and just do what needs to be done. I'm just moving it further away from me. Wait, I need to detach the. There we go. Get off of me, you stupid car! Yes, that one, thanks.
Oh, God.
It's fine, don't worry about it.
You know...
No. We've come this far.
It's still a possibility.
What is?
I know you want to make this 1 minute trailer into 1.5 minute trailer, but we have the choice to end this.
No, we don't. Hey, this is the snow cannon's actually making magical mountain into a real mountain now.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't really see anything.
It's good. Really?
It's just like super foggy.
Yeah, snow. You need to get pretty close to Magic Mountain before you see it, but it's there. It's there. I'll turn on the light so we can see a bit more. Turn, stupid pile of butts. I'm pretty sure that this car is actually made entirely out of human butts. Like, sometimes I just feel like this car is not made of real materials. It's just made out of the butts of unhappy people.
There's no catch business. It's nothing else.
It's a harsh life. A lot of people die to make this stupid thing, and everyone finds it idiotic. Both the entire creation process is stupid, and the entire driving process of it is stupid. But it has some pretty rad lights. Like, you don't want to know how you make a light out of a human butt.
Whoa.
Whoa?
Just you keep on driving.
Okay. I'm just driving through town right now.
Yeah, good. Okay. Go to my vehicle.
Hang on. I'll just drive it in, like, the right direction first, so I don't get stuck in, like, Lake Wallabaloo. Which I would. I might get stuck next to this tree, though.
Oh, my gosh.
I'll just go to your vehicle. Wait, hang on. Yeah, okay, there I am.
Yeah, like that door, that kind of sucks for that person, but I just said.
What?
That door, like, branch out of the vehicle.
Oh, that's a pretty good door. I guess it's been snowing a lot here.
Yeah. Maybe we should, like, groom around this house instead.
No, they're not very good people.
Okay. They weren't blocked inside.
They're not actually snowed in. They were just trapped by people that live here. It's the unfortunate life of people that eat children.
This game has a really dark backstory.
It's a very dark backstory. Like, those were the... There were three people that lived there called Jimmy, Bimmy, and Flimmy. And they were known for kidnapping and eating children. And the villagers were not having it, because without those children, whose butts are they going to use to create a new snow cat?
Oh, dear lord.
And, the people weren't having it, so... They banished them into the land of snow forever. Five ever, even. And now, They are forever stuck behind a door that will never open again. Oh, there's a little... Oh, that's cool. I like that.
You should go back to me.
No, you should check my vehicle out, because, like, the car that's stranded has, like, a little light that's flickering on and off as if to show, hey, I need help.
Oh, and yeah, that's adorable.
I can see it through the fog, and I think that's kind of adorable.
You should switch to me, because I have a very important point to point out.
Hang on. Okay, I'm going in the right direction. Yeah.
I think this store needs extra snow.
I think so too, because they couldn't fall down and hurt themselves. Wait, did that door just move? Like, if you move the camera backwards and forward, it moves.
Really? I'm not sure if I'm getting that.
I'm getting that. Like, if I move it forward, it like sinks into the house. But only from like a certain angle, I guess, maybe.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if
you move it far enough.
God,
yeah, whoa, the entire wall as well, just like the windows as well. What the hell?
It's really scary. I think that might be a ghost house.
Oh my god.
Maybe those are the ghosts that drive these vehicles.
Oh my god.
It all makes
terrifying.
Sense now, because like ghosts are often seen as like cold creatures with like sheets and stuff, because, you know, a sheet warms them up. And yeah, like the snow here isn't actually snow, it's just the souls of dead people. Wow, this guy's pretty stranded. Hey, this is the car that I was pushing all over the place, the one which you couldn't see. Cool. I already helped this one previously. Please. Do it. Do it like you mean it. Do it like you want it. I nearly had it. I nearly had it. I think this might actually be another mission where you could help me.
Ooh. Help.
Yeah. Like, when you see me, you can probably understand how I need your help right now.
Oh, invisible wall.
Nah.
Sometimes I think I have fun, but then I find invisible walls.
Yeah, that's usually how I feel about every game that Gearbox has ever made. Has Gearbox made any games recently at all, actually? Like, I just... Like, Gearbox is kind of my go-to guy for invisible walls, but I haven't... I don't actually remember the last game they made.
They released Aliens like months ago, I think.
Oh yeah, they made that game, didn't they?
Yeah, I think they made that alongside another company.
Yeah, I think that like the other company made like most of it, and then Gearbox just took it over and just made the rest, kind of like with Duke Nukem Forever.
And I guess before that it was Borderlands 2, and before that it was Duke Nukem Forever?
I guess so, yeah. I guess it's been pretty recent then. And Aliens vs. Predator was actually pretty good in terms of invisible walls. Like, you could just fall down and die everywhere.
Yeah.
That was pretty good.
Pretty good.
Yeah. I'm still impressed that we haven't seen a single person ski here, because when I started a multiplayer server, I saw, like, someone skiing here, and it was pretty good. But now, like, start one, and everyone's just gone. I guess everyone just prefers my skiing area over yours.
Oh.
Where are you, by the way?
I am trying to get to you, but I think I'm going the very, very wrong way.
Oh, you're all the way over there. Oh my god. Should I wait for you?
Am I going the right way?
Well, I'm just back at where we were.
Oh. I don't think I'm going the right way then.
Oh, that's not good.
Oh. I just got an idea for the cheat.
What?
Cheating. Log in. Meow. Did that work?
The car's driving off without me. Oh my god.
That did not work.
Will you please move? Why am I stuck right now? I did a thing and it didn't help. Q. Okay, there we go.
Oh, I found your one car which is kind of stuck in the fence.
You could help take that one out, maybe, because that one's in a rather unfortunate location right now.
Okay, I just reached you, but I can quickly fix that car. Just
God, move! I'm holding forward, and you're going backwards. I'm holding forward. I'm getting really mad at this game because it just drives backwards whenever it's. Freaking feels like it, and it's making it just keeps going backwards. Like, I have no control over this stupid thing. Oh,
well, I fixed that car,
and now it's continuously going forward when I'm trying to go back again. Like, I'll just not hold any other button except for going backwards. you please just give me the stupid prompt?
Whoa, freaking... sorry.
Whoa, what the hell? You attacked me with, like, a thing.
Sorry.
What even is this? How did you get this?
It was just lying around here.
Oh my god.
I felt very aggressive, I'm sorry.
I'm stuck now. Okay, there we go.
I like that, like, with half of the tasks, you have to use the Snowcat, like the small Snowcat, and only one player can use it.
Yeah, it's pretty good, isn't it?
That thing is moving by itself.
It's moving by itself.
It's still moving.
Yeah. Well, at least that means the netcode's pretty good sometimes when it comes to certain things. I'm holding backwards, by the way. Sometimes I move backwards a little bit. I'll press C every now and then.
Have you tried letting go backward and then pressing back again? I'll take that as a no.
Hey, it worked that time. God, stupid! I hate so much right now. I'm only feeling hateful feelings towards this stupid stranded car that the person just abandoned anyway. Like, clearly he didn't care about this car. Why should I care about it? But no. This game's like, yeah, you should help this game. You don't. It's been pretty impressive how long I've just been stuck in front of this car. You know what? Screw it. I'm not gonna use the tow thing. I'm gonna just push it away because clearly this car is not interested. Oh, now it gives me the prompt. You useless little piece of pile of poop. It gave me the prompt like so briefly that I was just not prepared for it at all.
You know, there's still the option.
Yeah, you say that, but I don't actually hear those words.
Also, what is the point of the mouse curse in this game? Is there anything to ever click on?
No.
Okay, just checking.
It's so you know where your mouse is. Well, I guess in the menu you click on things. Finally, okay. No more funny business. Don't you dare. Make funny business. You're daring. I can feel you daring at me.
Oh, it was so much fun. Like, we could have more footage for the trailer.
Oh, we already have enough footage, let's be honest. I can use this, I guess.
You know, the shadows, they do look funky, but they're also kind of impressive in a funky way.
Oh god, I was looking backwards.
Oh my Jesus.
Don't do it, car. Don't physics at me.
Oh my Jesus.
Oh, this game is using physics. Maybe that's why we're flying around all over the place.
Yeah. I wonder if we get to use the red car after we save it.
That'd be really cool, actually. Oh, it disappeared. It's 2 out of 2 this time.
Yeah, we did the first one.
Yeah, it was the same.
God.
Please don't say those words at me.
Car.
Please don't say my name in that tone.
How do I cheat?
Oh my god, this thing is out of fuel.
All your base are belong.
That only works in like Warcraft 3, I think.
End task.
Oh my god. The thing is, like, in this thing, it says like X to deactivate, D for detach, back plow, but none of those buttons actually do anything anymore with this thing. Like, I can just press both all the time. Does nothing.
Snowcat. Simulator.
You are searching for those cheats like your life depends on it.
Insomnia. Who published the game?
Oh god, it's like the air balloon developer.
Air?
Oh no. Am I just... Oh my god, you are not serious.
What?
Are not gonna do this to me, stupid little car. It's so close.
Come on! I should look at you while doing this.
Come on! Come on!
What do you do? Oh, the fuel!
Fuel! Yes!
Oh, wow, good job.
Oh, man, that was exciting.
Another moment for the trailer!
Yeah.
Sh- shitty fuck. Fuck.
Stop swearing at the game. It's too good for you. You're just jealous. You're just jealous you didn't create this gem.
I could search for strings in a hex editor.
I think you would have to restart the game entirely though to test that, don't you?
No, I think it would be possible to open up the executable.
Are you sure? While it's running?
I think it should be valid to like open it for reading.
Okay.
Like if I write it, maybe then I would get an error, but I think for reading it should be valid.
Okay.
Should I try that?
No. I'm scared. We've got let's finish task 10 because it's like a round number. If it turns out that it's like, yeah, here's task 11, go groom like the entire world outside of this key area, then fine. But if task 10, the round number task, does turn out to be the last one, then it would be a shame to have cheated our way through it.
Okay.
This stupid thing does not work at all.
Okay.
Press X to activate. Yeah, right. Except that X doesn't do anything.
I think Adam might have said something in a wrong chat.
Nice. What did he say?
In the Japanese Skype chat, he shouted, "People have already finished FF8 on Steam!"
Nice. I'm not overly surprised. This is pretty interesting. Also, I'm guessing those people just use achievement unlockers, to be honest. But, yeah, I can't actually use this thing.
Because I'm in it?
No, like, it was just not letting me activate it, but now it is. Like, when I switched vehicle and then switched back again, it was able.
It might have been because, I'm
going
to try to make sense of this.
Yeah, it's just this game being dumb.
I'm just going to try to cheat more.
Yeah, that would be a good plan, I think.
Did I Snowcat already?
I would say so. I would say that would be one of the first things you tried. Oh, don't.
Cheat.
Don't do this to me, bro. Don't do this to me, bro.
Cheat.
My brother.
Cheating.
Brother from another Carther. Carther. Car.
Rafael.
What? What?
Yeah.
You can't use Rafael as a cheat.
Yes.
I don't think that works
Quack.
That way. Quack? Quack!
What is the German word for cheat?
Build.
Build?
Yeah, B-I-L-D. That might be a lie, that might mean like photo. Or no, it means photo, it means statue in like a real language. You can use Google Translate, that probably knows.
Yeah.
I don't know the German word for cheating, actually. Yeah.
We should be streaming this so that people can do research for us, too.
Yeah, that would have made that, yeah. If you want, you could, you're playing, you can probably set up the stream right now, you could. So. Although that would probably lag the server and then the game would become unenjoyable.
The game is actually using a ton of bandwidth, holy shit.
Are you serious? How much?
It's uploading with 45 kilobytes the entire time.
What? Why?
So yeah, I can't.
Guess it like puts, it's pretty accurate when it comes to some of the like things like.
Yeah, it must be the physics.
Yeah, the physics and stuff. But seriously, 40? That's preposterous.
Yeah, and it's downloading with very little, so. So you are sending almost nothing to me, but I am uploading.
I guess
like everything.
Because you're the host or something, it just
yeah.
has like all the responsibilities of making everything work correctly. So yeah, I can't deactivate this thing again, which is pretty cool. This was a triumph. I'm making a note here. You're a tugboat. It's hard to overstate my satisfaction. Never this time. We do what we must. Because
weep, what we doing?
What are we doing, weep?
Why are we stuck in this cold hell?
I do not think this was a good idea.
I think Pod Simulator would have been better if it worked.
Yeah.
If only it worked, I was so happy. When I saw the start of this game, it had such potential. It looked so good.
So good.
But then we played it, man.
It was no good.
It was no good. Oh my god.
I need your help with this mission, by the way. Like, you could have been helping me out the entire time, but no, you're looking at a cheat.
Well, just imagine, like, if I suddenly figured out how to cheat, like, we would beat the game immediately.
That's a good point, I guess. Still, though.
But I guess I'll help you, I guess.
Yay.
Oh, god. We've been doing this for a really long time.
We've been doing this for hours.
I think that, like, since 5 or something, we've been trying to get this port simulator to work.
Yeah, we stopped trying at about 6:30-ish with port simulator. Then we started downloading this game. It was like 300 megabytes, but the download was pretty slow. So I would estimate we've been doing this for about 3 hours.
The download didn't take that long. I can remember I started up Assassin's Creed 4 when the download was around 50%, and I only had time to, like, board 2 ships, and that was it. And that isn't a lot of time.
Mm. I'm just laughing at our situation. I say, though, like, this is the last task of the game. Like, 10, that's a good number to end your game at. Hello, phone. Why'd you make that noise at me? Why did you make a noise at me?
Maybe you could also try to input cheats if you can guess the password.
Google Talk? What the hell?
What the hell?
Who uses that at me? What? I have no idea what that is. That's scary. What were you saying? Like, I should input cheats?
Yeah, you could guess the password.
Okay, hang on. I'm just gonna go all the way up, and then I'm gonna guess some passwords. Like, going down, I might as well just guess things while I'm moving downwards anyway. Because the physics in this game are pretty realistic, so when I go down a slope, it should go at a faster speed, and it wouldn't require the engine to be turned on, right? I guess with tracks that might actually not work the same way because they just naturally lock.
What if the game loops?
That would be hilarious. That would be so good. Okay, so okay. Like cheating, login.
Yeah, and then it's one word password and I don't know.
Does
not
take one parent, one, okay, one admin. Fluffy. Snowcat. Cheat. Login. SVW cheats 1. I guess that's 2 parameters. Login help. Cheat mode. Cheetos. Cheetaroo. Pancakes. Flamingo. Okay, I'm done.
Okay, good job. We're almost done with this. We're almost done.
The music got pretty intense. Wow, you got really far. What the hell?
I'm good. I'm really good at this.
Oh my! I guess while I was entering cheap possibilities, I pressed the detach key. So I'm just driving off without my trusty little groomer.
Wow.
Well, one of two. We did our goal, Sectus, the original goal of completing 10 tasks. I think we've finished the game. We've gotten a good feel about what this game is, and
I thought I get a chance to look for strings.
I think we've done a pretty good job here, and I'm glad that we did what we did. I feel that we've done a good job at cleaning this area out, and I'm pretty happy. Do you have any final words, Sectus, before I stop recording right now?
The password is listed here. I found it immediately.
What? Really?
Yeah.
What's the password?
It's Snowcat password with S, C, and P being capitalized and the O being a zero.
Password. Wait, the first O or the second O?
The last O. Snowcat pass. Okay, it's gonna now. End task.
It worked! There's so many tasks! There's so many tasks! Wait, what are removing obstacles?
Oh, I'm sorry for skipping many.
try to, like, find one that's removing obstacles. Groom, clear the road around the garage.
Oh no, is this... Some of these are very familiar.
Top right ski
Game trail. Completed!
Wait, that's not on my screen.
Really?
Yeah.
On my screen says game completed. You have successfully completed all the tasks.
It just kicked me out of the game.
Really?
I'll start a new game. And I'm gonna do that.
Oh my god.
Cheating, login, Snowcat password.
I am really surprised how easy it was to figure out the password. Like, I figured out in seconds, but just searching for strings and executable.
Ding, 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 ding. Wait, were those dinging sounds on your end the entire time when we finished the task?
You never heard
that. No, like, it just went to another one. Oh my god. Okay, and I guess the weather is, like, attached to events as well.
Yeah.
To remove obstacle under natural bridge. I'm just going to check that one out because I'm kind of curious what that actually even means.
Are you hosting?
No, I'm just doing single player right now.
Okay.
Let's see. Where is this large snow cat? This looks pretty large. Oh my god, it's so far away. So, Sectus, do you have any final words about this great game? Do you know how long it took us to finish 10 tasks and there were 33? 33!
Well, I guess it is actually a full-length game.
It definitely is a full-length game. My front plow is twitching like a madman, which is pretty great.
I am happy that...
There's skiers here! I'm gonna hit these.
Good. Maybe I should... Start Sinclair. I haven't seen Sinclair. Maybe there's like cutscenes.
No. There's two skiers though. Maybe they're only at like the very start and they just go down and then they just never come back up again. But now you saw what happens when I hit a skier. Video viewers who made it this far into the video for God knows what reason. Like, that is a pretty hardcore reasoning to not do studying. If you watch this entire video this far, because man, I wouldn't be able to do that personally. Sectus wouldn't be able to do that. Ryman might be able to do that. And I genuinely don't know of anyone else. I don't know why this thing is twitching so much, but it looks pretty great. I don't think I've been in this area, so that's kind of... It's like lights over there. Like, to be fair, like, the trees look alright.
Use large snowcat to remove obstacles on half pipe, and they misspelled obstacles.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, with an I?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the same for task number 12. I'm just curious what the obstacles are gonna be. Like, if it's gonna be rocks, or maybe it's gonna be mutant ninja turtles.
Well, it's a good thing you have realistic expectations.
It's a simulator. You know, it could happen at any point in time.
I'm looking on task 23 right now.
Which one?
Task 23.
Okay, I'm only on 12.
But wow.
I'm gonna look at these obstacles.
Oh my god, it's so far away.
Yeah. 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 And I'm stuck on the wall again. And I don't have
I don't think
here.
I'm very tempted to go all that way.
I am tempted to go all that way, and it's single player anyway, so whatever. I'll describe the details to you in great vividity. Vividity is probably a good word.
I'm gonna try the cheat, no fuel.
Does that just set your fuel to zero?
Yeah. Okay, so I can still move?
Yeah, I guess you can, because like my fuel is on zero and I was moving really slowly, but it did just keep moving.
Okay.
So I guess it just makes you move really slow, which is impressive because you already moved slow the entire game. And they found a way to make it even slower. And I find that quite impressive.
Oh my god.
I like that the host gets like a whole assortment of extra sounds and an ending though. I like that player too, and probably all the other ones don't actually get an ending. After completing 33 tasks. Like in duos. I'm so close to the obstacle sectors, I can smell them. The smell of victory sectors. I'm just gonna remove the stupid front. Just detach it. It's so sweet. It's very distracting.
I hope extreme sailing, whatever it's called, is a lot better than this.
I am not actually gonna be surprised if it isn't.
Like, at least I must have pretty water to look at.
Oh, yeah, of course it does. Oh, God. Am I gonna fall? That was tough.
I am kind of surprised, like, once we got into a game here, it worked for 3 hours without any problems.
Yeah, considering Port Simulator just crashed whenever we tried to, like, touch a button or breathe towards a button. And also the fact that player 2 in that game could just basically not do anything until player 1 had set up everything. Like, he just... Player 1 does everything, and player 2 drives around in the tugboat.
Yeah.
Also, the obstacle is a fallen over tree.
Wow.
Yeah.
Exciting.
Yep. Okay. Okay. End task. Cheating. End task. Small snow. No.
There's a command called level set which only works in multiplayer. What the hell does that mean?
I don't know.
I'm curious. Create server.
You have successfully completed all the tasks. Congratulations.
Ah. Okay, so with level set you can choose a specific task to do.
Wow, that sounds like fun. I can't find your server anymore, so I'm gonna look at credits. These are the credits.
I was hosting a LAN server, I'm sorry.
Oh, you useless bastard. But yeah, the publisher was UIG Entertainment, Insomnia, NVIDIA, and Physics, NVIDIA. And it was made by a bunch of people, and they made a bunch of other simulators, and they're all awful. So everyone should play all of them and then feel really, really bad. I'm gonna end my video here, I think. So, do you have any closing words, Sectus?
I'm glad it's over.
I'm pretty glad it's over, too.
I'm gonna quit.
I'm gonna see the leaderboards. Oh, wow. I completed mission... Oh, these are all offline, aren't they?
Yeah.
These are offline leaderboards.
Yep.
So you can compete to your friends in real life playing on the same PC.
Yep.
Goodbye forever. This game never again. I hope this sailing is better. Bye.
Bye.